1980 is a feature presentation of Television Sports USA, the Mizlou Television Network. From Giant Stadium in New Jersey, welcome to the third annual Garden State Bowl. Today, featuring two of the nation's outstanding college football teams. Coach Bill Yeomans leads his Southwest Conference power, Houston Cougars, against George Welsh's Midshipmen of Navy. Today's Garden State Bowl telecast is brought to you by Light Beer, everything you always wanted in a beer and less. By Volkswagen. Volkswagen does it again. By Prudential. For life, health, auto, home, get a piece of the rock. Prudential Insurance. And by the U.S. Navy. Navy, it's not just a job, it's an adventure. Good afternoon, everyone. From Giant Stadium, I'm Howard David for the Mizlou Television Network. Navy, a record of 8-3 on the season, including a win over Rose Bowl-bound Washington against Houston's Cougars. 6-5 on the year, an injury-riddled season for the Cougars, but they play in the tough Southwest Conference, and they may have to battle the cold weather here at Giant Stadium. It is sunny, but the temperature down in the 30s could present a problem for a team that is used to the sunshine of the Southwest. Handling the play-by-play for today's telecast is Bob Murphy.
Thank you, Howard. And not too many years ago, Duke came to New York City to play in the old Polo Grounds against Army. The captains that day, All-American Bill Yeoman, now the Houston very successful head coach, and of course the Duke All-American Al DeRogatis. Al, of course, well known throughout America. He has been a veteran analyst of football, both college and pro. Al, it's a pleasure to be back with you.
Bob, great to be with you. And it wasn't too many years ago for you, but it was a long time ago for me.
Well, the years kind of slide by, but we have a marvelous bowl game to work today.
The Garden State Bowl number 3. This could well be the most exciting one of 3 very good football games. The Navy team with discipline and consistency against a Houston team that really has been very inconsistent, but nonetheless can score.
So it'll be Navy from the East against Houston from the powerful Southwest Conference. We'll be coming back to take a look at the personalities in today's bowl game when we return in just a moment.
Citizen Watch has done something extraordinary with these 23 computerized functions. We put them in their place and created a beautiful watch around them. The Citizen Anna Digi, a classically elegant watch with a cleverly placed digital display. And the center crown controls all functions, a world's first for simplicity. The Citizen Anna Digi, the perfect combination of form and function. There's no such thing as an average citizen.
Hey! My best shot in years and nobody notices.
Because they can't see you anymore.
Pretty Brent, 5 feet 8, 180 pounds.
175.
Come with us.
Where?
Why?
Where you won't worry about your game.
Or anything else.
You mean it? Oh, no! I just bought a house. Yeah, my kid wants to be a doctor. I gotta rotate my tires.
Ah, but you do have Prudential Life Insurance, Freddie. Oh. That'll help take care of things.
My piece of the rock, oh yeah. First, I figured I was young, healthy.
Really?
Yeah, and couldn't afford it. Then my Prudential agent showed me how I could. Oh.
Prudential's special policy for growing families lets you start off with lower premiums. So now you can afford what you can't afford to be without. A piece of the rock.
I could get another piece of the rock tomorrow.
There are no more tomorrows.
For life, health, auto, home.
Get a piece of the rock.
Prudential Insurance.
This year, the Houston Cougars tied for second in the Southwest Conference race. They've been in the league 5 years. They have been such a force. And Al DeRogatis, Houston Cougar fans will never forget Terry Elston, the quarterback number 7, who was a hero all over America last year when he won the Cotton Bowl game for the Houston Cougars.
And the most valuable player. And this year, Terry has run into some difficult moments. Broke his wrist early on in the season, came back late in the year, showed a very consistent drive, has been a little inconsistent. Brent Shin, we might see him today, number 8.
And here is Linnell Fee. Now, he is a game breaker, number 15, a wide receiver.
And he's the man I want to look at. Not only does he have a 19-plus average for depth, he's got brilliant speed and is a great runner. Watch him.
Al DeRogatis appreciates line play the way few people do. He was an All-American as a lineman. Now here is a genuine All-American, Leonard Mitchell, number 7. He weighs only 280.
And he's only 6'7", which isn't too bad. The pro scouts are all over this stadium today because that's the man they're looking at, and he's a good one.
So Navy perhaps will be going against a team that they'll be giving away some weight to. That's not unusual for Navy, though. They're a scrappy football team, and number 26 is Fred Reitzel. He's a quarterback for the first time this year, Al.
He's the prototype of Navy. Good run and good pass.
And Eddie Myers, the tailback, number 40.
Probably the best athlete on the field for Navy.
And when it comes to Mike Dolan, the center, we point him out because of the big job he has to do.
Jose Taylor is 265 pounds, a great defensive lineman. That's where the contest could be told today.
We have a lot of interesting things to watch here this afternoon at beautiful Giants Stadium. We'll be right back after a word from your local station.
Lineup for the U.S. Naval Academy. At left end, number 48.
Who's that?
It's our director. Oh, you're right.
You look good, though.
I didn't know. I didn't recognize him.
That belongs to the midshipman.
Victor, you need a shave.
Is it taking the place of the goat? So the gorilla's just kind of a gag, huh?
Looks like a girl I went out with once. Still didn't shave.
When are they coming to us, do you say?
We have a beautiful afternoon here at beautiful Giants Stadium for our Garden State Bowl game between Navy and Houston. And here are the very successful head coaches. On the left, George Welch of Navy, a great quarterback for the midshipmen during his playing days. And Bill Yeoman, the man we talked about earlier who played against Al DeRogatis. He wound up at Army, and so, Al, in a way, it's an Army-Navy matchup again.
It sure is. And one of the great moments was really Bill Yeoman in 1948. That great game, the year of Glenn Davis and Doc Blanchard, when they were supposed to overwhelm the Navy, and they beat Navy 21-20. When you think of the class of the man, he gave the captain, Bill Yeoman, he gave the ball to the Navy team.
Those are the hand warmers. It's about 33 degrees right now, but Al, those will be helpful.
You know, also in that story I was just relating, actually he got a great letter, Bill Yeoman, from President Harry S. Truman.
And he has that letter framed and hanging in his den at his home in Houston, Texas. You can imagine how proud he is. Now watch for the coin toss, because I have a feeling that if Houston wins the toss, they will take the win. The wind is out of the northwest at about 15 to 20 miles per hour. The referee is C.C. Daly, and the referees are from the ECAC this afternoon. Steve Bradham and Terry Elston, number 1 and number 7, are the co-captains for the Houston Cougars. And for Navy, Frank McAllister, ineligible because of his scholastic eligibility ran out, will not be able to play today. His absence will be felt. Terry Hupsel is number 54, and the coin toss. We'll check the Navy offense up front at left tackle, Craig Smith. At Steve Hooper, Mike Dolan is the man at center, Bob Tufel and Keith Borney. The front five in the offensive line for the Naval Academy. The wide receivers are Dave Dent, number 86. He is excellent. The leading receiver on the Navy team is Kurt Gaynor, the tight end, number 87. And the wing back is Greg Papajohn, number 82. In the backfield, the quarterback, senior Fred Reitzel, he was a safety his first 2 years. Eddie Myers closing out at 1,000 yards, number 40. And the fullback, an excellent blocker, is Kevin Tolbert. Defensively, the front five for Houston, Kelly McDonald and Alvin Rubin are the ends. All-American Leonard Mitchell and Terry Monroe are the tackles. Another All-American who moved over to nose guard, number 90, Hosea Taylor. The linebacker, Steve Bradham, a senior, number one, leads the team in tackles, and Grady Turner, number 40. In the defensive secondary for the Cougars, Donnie Love will be at a cornerback along with Reggie Vonner. And deep, it's Larry Curry, number 48, and Albert Windham, number 2. And so the Cougars will have the wind, as they talked about, and going deep to receive for Navy as we prepare to start the football game will be number 25. John Ross will be on the receiving end along with Dwayne Flowers. Now here is your barefooted kicker, Jeff Schaefer. The regular kicker all season long for the Houston Cougars, of course, has been David Humphreys. David had to remain behind to handle his studying. And so the officials for our football game this afternoon, the referee is C.C. Daly. He'll be helped by Clark Gaston, Bill Cummings, Jack Rhodes, Bill Davis, and Doug Rhodes. But Jeff Schaefer, a sophomore from Klein, a northwest suburb of Houston, Texas, a barefooted kicker. Now, he has been kicking off all year long, but this is the first time that he will be handling the specialty kicking during the football game. Because David Humphreys did not make the trip, he felt it wise that he remained behind and really hit the books. And so, on a beautiful, rather chilly afternoon, our football game is underway. Dwayne Flowers, number 25, gathers it in at his own 9-yard line. Back to the 20, to the 25, hit down on the 27-yard line. Flowers goes down on the 27-yard line. So it'll be first and 10 for Navy from their own 27. They'll be traveling into the northwest wind here in the first quarter of the football game. Navy 8-3 on the year, 24-10 over the last three seasons. Kevin Tolbert, number 30, is the fullback. Eddie Myers, number 40, is the tailback. Will Reitzel, 26, the quarterback, handing off to Eddie Myers. Eddie Myers to the 30-yard line. A fumble. I believe Houston has claimed the fumble. A very early turnover by a team that rarely turns it over.
Now, isn't that interesting? We talked at the top of the show about the Houston Cougars being the fumbling team. The play that we watched very carefully, and they ran right at him, was Hosea Taylor. There was a fairly good hole. They were double-teaming. Myers rarely coughs it up, but he did it then. Watch the double-team now, right over the middle there. They're attacking the center, and you'll see this popping out. They closed that middle. They wedged it right up there. They went at the strength of Houston. Well, the entire team really converged. Here's the Houston team.
Kelly McDonald, the defensive left end, recovered the fumble. Houston goes on the attack. Terry Elston giving the ball off to Eddie Wright. And it'll be a gain to about the 25-yard line. Make it Terrell Clark, number 26, the tailback. Elliot Reagans of Navy makes the tackle. So a very early turnover on the very first play from scrimmage. The Cougars are on the 25-yard line of the midshipmen. It is second down and 4 yards to go for Houston. Terrell Clark, 26, the leading ground gainer, is the tailback, and David Barrett, number 18, is the fullback in the Houston Bear. Bill Yeoman, the father of the Bear. They fake to the, it goes into the fullback, Barrett, number 18, over the 20 to about the 19. That'll be very close. It is a first and 10. David Barrett, the fullback, a junior who weighs 215, gets a first down for Houston. Steve Chambers and Mike Kranzer made the tackle. Interestingly enough, as Al DeRogatis points out, here is Navy, a team that had turned it over so little all year long. They averaged only about 1.1 a football game. Houston, on the other hand, has been troubled by turnovers. This is first and 10. Terry Elston, quarterbacking for the Cougars, spins around, gives the ball off to the tailback Terrell Clark. Terrell Clark to the 15-yard line. Mike Rouser, number 84, is getting up, along with Steve Chambers of Navy, number 73, and Ted Doomball, number 69, the linebacker. It's second down, 8 yards to go, Houston.
You just saw a beautiful reverse pivot by the quarterback, faking to his right side, turning to his left side, taking the Navy team with him and hitting behind it. Good strategy.
And we get an indication of the wind right there, Al, as the ball rolls away with the help of the wind. The wide receivers for the Cougars, Linnell Fee, number 15, and Eric Herring, number 21. This is second down and 7 for the Cougars on the midshipman 15-yard line. Terry Elston, the senior quarterback. Elston to Dave Barrett, number 18, the fullback, down to about the 10-yard line. third down and short yardage coming up. Ted Doombald, number 69, the talented linebacker of the Midshipmen, made the tackle.
The way that Navy defense is playing, it looks like they are going to be playing the option, the possibility of that quarterback either keeping or pitching out. We got to keep our eye on that far side of the football field where number 48 is playing, Wallington. He could be a factor.
Third down, a yard to go. Barrett, number 18, the fullback across the five. First down, fumble, loose ball. I believe Houston has recovered on the 1 yard line. Barrett got the first down. The ball came loose, was covered, and it was ruled dead at about the 2 yard line where it's 1 yard line where it's a first down. So David Barrett, the fullback, a junior out of Corpus Christi, getting the first down. Houston started from the 30-yard line after recovering the fumble. And now it's first down, a yard and a half, and goal to go. The wide receiver is Linnell Fee. Keep your eye on the setbacks. Clark, number 26, and Barrett, the fullback, number 18. Terry Elston, the quarterback. That's Terrell Clark. And he's over the goal line for a touchdown, I believe. Let's wait. A little short, Al.
Shades of the old Rose Bowl game with Slam Bam Cunningham. And this is prototype. The offensive line goes in there low, trying to keep that defense down, goes over the top, and here comes Conjure hitting him head on. Super play. It's going to be awfully tough to stop them here, though.
This is second down, as close as they can be without a touchdown. Clark, the setback on the left, and Barrett, the junior fullback, on the right. Harry Elston is the quarterback for the Cougars. And Elston has the football, and he does not score. He is fought standing up by Mike Kranzer, number 63, the right linebacker. Kranzer really going to war.
This is beautiful. This is goal line stand at its very best. Here comes Kranzer again. 48 is closing. Wallington is closing in on him. Look at this effort it's spinning. Now, this is something, really, Bill Yeomans doesn't want his team to do. He likes those shoulders straight ahead. That's when you're vulnerable to the fumble.
Bill Yeomans goes to two tight ends. Miller and Ford are in the game. This is third down inches for the Houston Cougars early in the football game here at Giant Stadium. And this time, they cannot stop Terrell Clark. Terrell Clark goes in. It is his sixth touchdown of the season. And so the Cougars have capitalized. They recovered a fumble on Navy's first play from scrimmage, and they have moved the 30 yards to get the touchdown. Scoring from inches out, Terrell Clark. And on to try the point after touchdown will be the barefooted kicker from Klein, Texas, Jeff Schaefer. Again, and so the Cougars are on the board early.
Again, that low driving offensive line keeping them down, and Clark goes over the top. Little bit of a surprise, wasn't it, Bob?
Greg Harmon, a defensive end, number 44, is the holder. The ball is down. The kick by Jeff Schaefer is on the way. The kick is good. And so the Cougars, driving 30 yards after recovering a fumble, have taken the early lead in the third annual Garden State Bowl game. They lead by a score of 7-0. We'll be coming right back.
When I was coaching, I was the boss. I used to feed them, dress them, get them to bed on time. Now I treat them to our favorite beer, right?
Light beer from Miller.
Light's got a third less calories than the regular beer. And what else?
It's less filling, Red.
And they really like the taste. Another beer, anyone?
Yeah.
What's the magic word? Please.
Leg beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
Sony introduces the art of watching television. The Sony Betamax lets you record and see what you want, when you want, to summon into your home a world of wonder. And a remarkable feature called Betascan lets you scan forward and reverse to quickly find any single image. Betamax transforms the act of watching television into the art of watching television.
Your show is about to begin.
Sony, the one and only.
Some great viewing coming up on the Mizlou Television Network this Friday night from San Diego, California, the Holiday Bowl with the SMU Mustangs and the BYU Cougars. Should be an exciting, wide-open type football game.
2 years ago, Navy won the Holiday Bowl game, and it was an exciting ball game. Jeff Schaefer, the barefooted kicker, deep to receive Dwayne Flowers and John Ross of Navy. The kick that is going with the win. Flowers, 25 of Navy from his 10-yard line. Now the 20, 25, hit down at about the 27-yard line. So the return almost identical to the return that started our football game this afternoon here at beautiful Giants Stadium.
Here's the finesse.
So for the midshipmen, it'll be first and 10 at their own 28. I'm sorry, Al.
It's okay, Bob. The finesse of the veer and the power of the veer. He could go inside or he can go outside or he can go over the top, but Clark was going to go in. Well done. Kind of a critical series, believe it or not, early on. They've got to establish something. They have to control the football.
Fred Reitzel, the senior quarterback for the midshipmen. They are behind early in the football game. The tailback is Eddie Myers. He has such a good one. Going over the 30 and out to about the 33-yard line.
They may be outweighed, Bob, but they move off that football. Even on that fumble, they were moving across that line of scrimmage. That's where the battle is going to be told.
Bill Yeoman, the Houston coach, his 19th year as head man of the Houston Cougars, number 8 on the all-time winning list among college coaches. Eddie Myers, by the way, starts the afternoon with 957 yards on the season. But apparently he is back in time. This is the second down 3 play. Tolbert, the fullback. Kevin Tolbert, the senior fullback, and that will not be a first down. He's hit down at the 35-yard line.
Okay, now this defense obviously is going to take away Kevin Tolbert or Eddie Myers. Now that means that Freddie Reitzel, who runs fairly well, does not have great speed, more than likely is going to be faking that handoff and keeping it himself to the outside.
Eddie Myers to the sideline for a moment, checking into the football game. Matt McLaughlin and going wide. For the midshipman is Dave Dent, the split end, number 86. Reitzel throwing for Dent. It is incomplete. He was trying to hit Kurt Gaynor or Dave Dent. Gaynor, the tight end, number 87. Dent, the split end, number 86. And for Navy, it'll be fourth down and 4, and the punting team will come on the field. Lex Lauletta does the punting. Going deep to receive will be Linnell Fee, number 15. And he's the game breaker that Al talked about earlier. Marvelous speed. Lex Lauletta, number 81, back to punt for Navy, standing on his own 22-yard line. He's punting into this northwest wind of about 15. Oh, it may have been slightly touched. Very short kick going out of bounds on about the 48-yard line of the midshipman. Al, I couldn't tell whether that was touched or not.
Awfully close to it. He was going for the foot. That's the way you should go.
So the score, 7-0 Houston. We're very early in the football game. We'll be coming back with more of the action in just a moment.
Volkswagen introduces exciting news about the 1981 Rabbit. New improved seats for a smoother, more comfortable ride. It has a new, bigger engine for more highway passing power, yet it gets even better mileage. New look inside and out, back and front.
Wait a minute. It's still basically a rabbit, isn't it?
That's the best news of all.
Volkswagen does it again.
The first electronic football games like these were for only one player.
End run.
But something was missing.
Can I play?
Wait your turn.
Then along came head-to-head electronic football by Coleco.
Now we can play at the same time.
I'm offense.
I'm defense.
With head-to-head, you're really in the game. A power sweep. He fights through for the tackle. You pass. He blitzes. Intercepts.
This is real competition.
Why settle for a one-player game when you can have it all? Play alone, against the computer, or for real competition, play
head-to-head.
Why settle for less?
Defensive end Leo Truss did get a hand on the punt. It became a very short kick. Second marvelous field position for Houston. First and 10 on the midshipman 43. And the Cougars of Bill Yeoman already in the lead. This is Carroll Clark, the tailback, number 26. Across the 40 and down to about the 37-yard line. Steve Chambers, senior defensive tackle from La Mirada, California, makes the stop for the midshipman. Carroll Clark, the talented tailback. This year, coming into the game, he had rushed for 859 yards. Gain of 6, second down and 4 for Houston. Cougars very anxious to make up for their last game of the season. The wide receivers for Houston, Eric Herring is number 21, lined up to the near side of the field. Linnell Fee, number 15, to the top of the screen. Terrell Clark, this time, hands the ball off. The play will go down for a first down to about the 30-yard line. Terrell Clark And Clark off to a good day. Now has about 28 yards here in the early minutes of the football game. Paul Soares made the tackle.
Well, as you're watching at that Navy defense, there is a great deal of concern about the wide speed of Houston. Mike Rouser, number 84, is playing it straight across. They're doubling on the defensive right tackle, and they're taking it to the outside. They can run wide to the left.
Darrell Clark and David Barrett are the setbacks in the rear now for Bill Yeoman as Elston keeps it. And he's sitting down at about the line of scrimmage. He'll gain about a yard. Steve Chambers of Navy, the defensive left tackle, making a good, strong play.
All right, now keep in mind the Houston offense likes to go to Eric Herring short. Let's watch Dumbold here, number 69. Two excellent linebackers for the Navy football team. You think he's determined there? Good move in, but didn't do it.
Ted Dumbold and Mike Kronzer, two outstanding linebackers for the Middies. And this for Houston is second and nine down on the 30-yard line of the midshipmen. And too much time.
The thing, Bob, I was trying to develop, but here's a situation where Eric Herring, they like to use him short. Now, he's number 21. But on the far side of the field, we're watching Lloyd Reagans giving an awful lot of room to number 15, Lonel Fee. You can't give Fee that kind of a room. You're frightened of him, of course, deep. But he can murder you short.
Delay of the game against the Houston Cougars. Second down, 14. The ball for Houston is on the Navy 35-yard line. The Cougars with the early lead, 7-0. Time remaining in the first quarter here at beautiful Giant Stadium in New Jersey. It's 7-0, and the time remaining is 7:16 in the first quarter. Again, the setbacks in the rear. Terrell Clark, the tailback, number 26, and David Barrett, number 18, is the fullback. Terrell Clark has the football into the secondary. Terrell Clark breaks a tackle, goes all the way to the 20-yard line. He'll be close to a first and 10. Talented Terrell Clark.
This man right now is ranking about, I think he's the sixth leading rusher in the history of this team. And watch the way he moves, reading the defense extremely well. That's the beauty of that deep back. He has to read the defense and read the hole. Good runner, good balance.
Third down, just inches to go for a first and 10. That was a run of about 13 and a half yards by tailback Terrell Clark. And he's off to a rather sensational afternoon here in New Jersey. And it's the quarterback, Elston, number 7, first down. Quarterback keep first and 10 as he gets about 2 on the play. Travis Wallington of Navy, number 48, the defensive end, made the stop, and the Cougars, who put one opportunity on the scoreboard, are now trying to put a second one on the board.
Well, that defense of the Navy obviously is being tested very early. 14 points behind early on this football team is awfully difficult to come back against.
During the regular season, Bill Yeoman won the toss against Texas Tech, took the win, put his defense on the field, wound up with 17 quick points. He followed that strategy here this afternoon. Terrell Clark, the tailback, on a delay. Steps through the line of scrimmage and down to about the 12-yard line. Jeff Shoemake and Terry Huxel. Huxel, number 54, the co-captain, who alternates at middle guard with Tim Jordan for Navy, coming in to make the tackle.
That was a good example of the veer, Bob, and what the veer can do. They take the fullback and move him to the right side, taking the flow of the defense with him. Clark goes up into the hole. If it isn't open there, he just veers it to the outside.
This is second and 5 for the Cougars. Lonel Fee and Eric Herring are the wide receivers. Terrell Clark and David Barrett are the setbacks in the Houston veer. Terrell Clark takes the handoff to about the 7-yard line. Rusty Smith and John Rusty Smith, number 20, working along with John Ross on the tackle. So now third down, and here's another third and inches play coming up.
And more than likely, they'll just take it straight up. But once again, you saw Elston take it to the left side. He did hand off. However, that pitch would have gone for a touchdown.
On third and inches, Alan Polk, number 32, is in as a tailback, replacing Terrell Clark. Keeping the ball is Elston. Elston very close to the goal line. Terry Elston tripped up by Jeff Shoemake, the safety for Navy, number 14. He has a first down.
Here's something this man likes to do. He's 6'4", and he's 210 pounds, and he's an awfully good athlete. Moves there, gets the defensive end in a bind, doesn't know which way to go, and the quarterback takes it to the inside. That's fumbled possibilities when you hold a football like that.
Tough job for Navy here. First down and goal to go. The wide receiver is Eric Herring, number 21. And the running play, Terrell Clark, who came back in. He was out for only one play. Navy rising up to stop him short of the goal line. So the midshipman will not yield. Travis Wallington is there standing up to help make the tackle, along with Ted Dumball. It'll be second down, inches and goal.
I guess what we didn't expect, Bob, was a fumble by Navy or a blocked punt. And the partially blocked punt gave Houston great field position. They can rip it open right now. But Navy doesn't quit very easily.
And until now, Navy have been almost impeccable all year long in not making football mistakes, in not turning the ball over. This is the second down and a yard to go for a touchdown. Carroll Clark and David Barrett. Elston, the quarterback, still with the football, and he goes over for a touchdown. So Terry Elston, the talented quarterback, has scored the touchdown. And the Cougars have an early 13-0 lead. They started on the 43-yard line, so this is a 43-yard drive. Earlier, they claimed a fumble and drove 30 yards. They are out in front now by a score of 13-0. That took 10 plays to cover the 43 yards.
In last year's Garden State Bowl, the Temple football team started exactly the same way with 21 points in the first quarter, only to find the University of California to come back and make a whale of a game of it. This game's a long, long way to go.
Greg Harmon is the holder of the kick by the sophomore Jeff Shaver from Klein, Texas. It is perfect. And so the Cougars, striking early, have taken a 14-0 lead. And we have 3:43 left to play in the first quarter of the third annual Garden State Bowl. We'll be right back.
John Burns joined the Army in March and kept us waiting until October. Kathy Wolf joined the Army in May and kept us waiting all summer. If you're a high school graduate or about to be, you can join the Army now and take up to 12 months to report for duty. That way, if you qualify, we can guarantee you the skill training that makes you happiest. And we think a happy soldier is worth waiting for. This is the Army, a chance to serve your country as you serve yourself. Call this number toll-free.
What a night! Blizzards in Alaska, typhoons in Tahiti, this close to a 747. And those snacks the kiddies leave, peanut butter in Poughkeepsie, bloodwurst in Bavaria. Oh, it's good to be home.
For headache and upset stomach, nothing works better, nothing is more soothing than Alka-Seltzer. No wonder it's America's home remedy.
Eggnog in Amsterdam, plum pudding.
George Welch, the Navy coach, switching his deep men, John Ross, to the near side where the ball has been going this side, and Dwayne Flowers will go to the far side as they get set deep to receive. Jeff Schaefer, the barefooted kicker. And this is John Ross, number 31, catching at the 10. Each time it has started from the 10, 25, and out of bounds on the 27-yard line. Al, that's about the third time in a row it's come back to that point, the 27.
Looks like Bill Yeoman's strategy is working. Take the win. Let's take another look at that touchdown. Now, this quarterback, as I mentioned, is 6'4", and he's about 210. Not a good passer, but he's an awfully good athlete. Watch the way he's holding that football. Now, somebody could pick that off. He whips it around. That gets Bill Yeoman just a little nervous. But he scored.
Well, the midshipman now trailing 14-0, first and 10 from their own 28. Here comes Eddie Myers, the tailback, across the 30. And to the 32, a gain of about 4 by Eddie Myers from Pemberton, New Jersey. 5'9", 203 pounds. Steve Bradham and Reggie Vonner converging to make the tackle for the Cougars. So the time remaining in the first quarter, 3 minutes and 24 seconds. And the Cougars with an early 14-0 lead, and we'll be coming right back.
Nice race, fellas.
That's a nice-looking car. What is it?
What do you think it is?
I don't know. A Volvo?
Nope.
A BMW?
Actually, it handles something like the 320i. It's got a much bigger trunk and more room inside.
It's not a Mercedes.
It's a Jetta.
A Jetta. What's a Jetta? I never heard of it.
Yeah, it's brand new.
Who makes it? Volkswagen? It doesn't look like a Volkswagen.
What's wrong with that?
Volkswagen does it again.
College football is a uniquely American game. From the first contest more than 100 years ago to the present day, no game more reflects the fabric of American society. Hello, everybody. This is Keith Jackson. And now there is a place which brings the rich history of college football right to you. The new College Football Hall of Fame at Kings Island, Ohio, on Interstate 71 just north of Cincinnati. It's a piece of Americana you should see.
Let's take a look at this. Now, I know George Welsh had to worry about this. Carrying the ball in that right arm, they keep telling you, keep it away from that side. Now, he really gets hit. They're gang tackling. He's the man they've got to stop. He walked off. He seems all right.
Mike Sherlock replaces Eddie Myers at tailback. This is Sherlock, and a beautiful defensive play made for Houston by Terry Monroe, the junior defensive right tackle. He's the young man that Bill Yeoman wanted to get in there to play every play almost, and so he moved Hosea Taylor to nose guard.
You know, looking at this defense that the Houston team is playing, and they're playing it very tough, the thing that could work is something short over the middle, coming underneath that defense.
The wide receiver, number 86, is Dave Dent. He is a fine pass-catching talent. This is third down and six. They may be looking for him. Fred Reitzel is under pressure, but he gets the pass away. It is deflected and caught for Navy by Papajohn. Greg Papajohn catches the deflection, and it becomes a Navy first and 10.
Well, he was going underneath just the way we thought he might. Papajohn keeps his eye on that football. He's going really the offside. Hits him in a very vulnerable place. Not bad, not bad. That's a drill you work at, but you don't put that in your playbook.
So it's a Navy first down at their own 39-yard line. Tight end Kirk Gaynor moves over to the left side. First and 10, Fred Reitzel spins around. Reitzel, the quarterback, running the football. Gains about three, maybe four. He's out to about the 40-yard line.
You know, one of the tough things is playing nose guard. And when you're playing nose guard, as big as this Hosea Taylor is, he's 6'5". Some people argue that a nose guard at that size is a little vulnerable to getting his legs cut out from under him. We're going to keep watching number 90. They did a good job on him on that last play.
Second down and five for Navy. This is the tailback, Mike Sherlock, number 23. Very little this time. Only about a yard as he tries to hit that big Houston middle. Hosea Taylor and Leonard Mitchell, number 70.
Let's watch 6'7", 271 pounds move. Just a little stronger than most folks. Fights off everybody. They close down on the middle. Everyone is there. Wrong place, Navy. They're going to have to put that football up. That's what the Houston team is really telling Navy. You're going to have to do it.
And they're playing without. Oh, fumble recovered by Fred Reitzel. Now it'll be fourth and long for Navy. Tough break. That was a passing down. It was third down and four. And the fumble on the exchange makes it a punt situation. It's pretty obvious right here, Al. I would say that Navy, in the early going, is missing their outstanding offensive tackle, Frank McAllister. That's Lonell Fee, number 15 of the Cougars, dropping deep to receive. Lex Lauletta does the punting for Navy. Lauletta with an average of 41.1 for the 11-game college season. Remember, he boots into the wind, and the flags are going to be thrown. Contact was made. Was he drawn off? It is against Navy. So it's a frustrating first quarter so far for Navy, and for the Midshipmen, the quarter is about over. 28 seconds remaining. They will have a rather strong north wind following them in the second quarter of the football game. But Lauletta right here with 28 seconds to go will be punting into the wind. Houston leading 14 to nothing. The Cougars playing a brilliant first quarter, getting their opportunities, putting them on the board. Lauletta hits it beautifully into the wind. Lonell Fee, number 15, decides they will let it roll. Did it touch him? And a scramble. Davies football, I believe, will wait. It went off of the shins of a Houston Cougar. And Navy pounces on at about the 24-yard line of Houston. And we have a penalty flag thrown at the 32.
Let's take a good look at this now. One thing you must do is stay away from the football. He didn't stay away from the football. Now watch this. Hits him. Goes for it. And there's the Navy on top of it. Another big, big break. That's number three, Bob. Gonna hit him right in the knee. And the Navy team is going to pounce on it.
It ricocheted off of Larry Curry. Navy has the football. And time has just about expired. Clipping also on the play against the Houston Cougars.
And you can't ask, I'm sorry, Bob, I was going to say, you can't ask for a better break. Now, with 11 seconds to go, they've got the football, and in the short time, they're going to have the win. And they know it. Probably keep the ball on the ground for this play, I would think.
Probably the last play of the first quarter on the Houston 24-yard line. First down, Navy. Fred Reitzel to Mike Sherlock, number 23, the tailback, Leonard Mitchell. The All-American defensive tackle, 6'7 and 280 pounds, rides him hard as time runs out in the first quarter of the third annual Garden State Bowl game from beautiful Giant Stadium in New Jersey. We'll be back for the second quarter when we return in just a moment. After these messages from your local station.
Who's that down? Can you hear me downstairs?
Be sure you give that one to me when you have much local station. Mike Sherlock went out with a minor injury on the last play. Myers and Sherlock both out now. This is second down and nine. Dwayne Flowers in a tailback. Tolbert, the fullback, number 30, across the 15 and down to about the Houston 13. That should be a first and 10 for the midshipman. Alvin Rubin, junior defensive end from Baytown, Texas, made the tackle. But the ball carrier was Kevin Tolbert, the senior fullback. So we repeat that the first two Navy tailbacks, both on the sidelines at the moment, Eddie Myers and Mike Sherlock, and Dwayne Flowers, a junior from Rockville, Maryland, number 25, is now in as the tailback. The wide receivers are Dent and Papajohn. First and 10 for Navy. Fred Reitzel looking toward the end zone, throws. Oh, it is almost intercepted by Reggie Bonner, number 6, the right cornerback of the Houston Cougars. He was trying to locate Dave Dent, the split end over in the corner.
It wasn't bad strategy. Some might question, why do you do that? Well, he figured, I'm sure George Welch figured it, the Houston team is going to be playing it tight, and maybe he could beat them underneath with something quick. But again, Tolbert, number 30, now is going to have to carry the load. Speed oftentimes can beat bigness.
On second and 10, the wide receivers are Dave Dent and Greg Papajohn. Here comes Dent in motion, and they'll give to Dent on the reverse. Dave Dent to split end, and the Houston Cougar defense will not be fooled. It is stopped cold by Grady Turner, number 40, playing the cornerback for the Houston Cougars. Big play coming now for the midshipmen. It is third down and 11 yards to go.
We didn't have a chance to ask George Welch the question, but here's a situation where I do not think the Houston team would be looking for a screen. They're going to be looking for a pass, but a screen to the top of your picture could work very effectively.
Dent and Papajohn, the wide receivers, Talbert and Flowers are the setbacks in the eye. Reitzel spinning around. Reitzel running the football to the 10 and dropped. On the 10-yard line, dropped by Calvin Eason. They call him Easy. He plays it well. He's just a sophomore coming on strong for the Houston Cougars, and it's fourth down coming. And Steve Fair, the Navy field goal kicker, will be coming on the field. By the way, he's number 5 in the entire nation in field goals. He hit 17 out of 23, including a 50-yarder against Army. Dave Dent, number 86, the wide receiver, will be holding. The ball will be placed on the 16, a try of 26 yards by field goal kicker Steve Fair. The ball is down, the try by Fair is hooked wide to the left. It is no good. It is no good. And the ball goes over to the Houston Cougars. And so it'll be Houston first down when we come back to the action here at beautiful Giant Stadium with Houston leading 14-0. We'll be...
Ah, a Volkswagen Rabbit diesel.
I'm not the best-selling diesel in Europe.
Why'd you buy yours?
Because I make 20 trips between Glasgow and Edinburgh every year. And you have to think of economy.
20 trips across Scotland? Even a rabbit must use a lot of fuel.
Aye.
Last year, I had to buy 2 full tankfuls.
Volkswagen does it again.
Missile exercise, Atlantic Range.
25
The Navy. Over 75% of our jobs give you technical training. Get one.
Target's turning starboard outbound.
2, 1, fire. Birds away.
Navy. It's not just a job. It's an adventure.
Houston 14-0 early in the second quarter, and after the missed field goal try by the midshipmen, the Cougars first and 10 on their own 20-yard line. We have overcast skies now. It was a bright sunny day earlier, and the temperature appears to be dropping a little bit. Terry Elston is running his team well, and is the ball loose? It may be, but I don't think so, as the handoff goes to David Barrett, and Paul Soares of Navy, number 67, was making a lot of defensive contact. Loss of 3, maybe a long 2, second down and 12. Bill Yeoman uses his tight ends as the messengers, Hubert Miller and Mark Ford. They alternate as the tight end and bring the plays in from the head man. Terry Elston, the quarterback for the Houston Cougars. The hero of the Cotton Bowl victory over Nebraska a year ago. Elston on a delay, handing the ball off to Clark. It is loose and scrambled for. I believe Navy has recovered on the 36-yard line. Navy has the football. And so Houston has turned it over.
Let's take a look at this. Coach Bill Yeoman says it's a matter of concentration. There's excellent blocking up front. They've closed it off. They've given Clark a beautiful hole. Watch how he's losing that handle. Now, it could be the chill factor. He's reaching for the football. That's an excellent play by the defensive back also. John Ross. John blocked the runner.
And that was Ken Fancher.
He really enabled the fumble to be recovered. That was an excellent play. Bad carrying, I must admit.
Ken Fancher, number 36, the defensive end of Navy, recovered. Tom Tarquinio has come in as the quarterback. Number 17, he's a good passer. He throws, it's deflected. It is incomplete. Tom Tarquinio, a sophomore, put in the game now by George Wells, trying to get a passing game going against the Cougar defense, which has really been tough so far.
Well, when you lose Eddie Myers and you lose your number 2 back, Sherlock, you have to go to the air. Both times they were going at Leonard Mitchell. He is awesome in there.
For Navy, second down and 10, Dave Dent goes out of the game as a wide receiver, and Steve Callahan, who was a tailback his first 2 years at Navy and a very good running back, then moved out to a wide receiver. Callahan comes into the game and flanks wide along with Greg Papajohn as they go to 2 wide receivers to the far side of the field. Remember, the young passer, Tom Tarquinio, is in the game. Sherlock is back in the game, number 23. And the tailback runs to the 30-yard line. That leaves him about 3 away from a Navy first down.
Again, the passing play that did work earlier, despite the fact that it was a deflection, was kind of short and underneath. So again, the top receiver, although he doesn't have brilliant speed, is Gaynor, the tight end, number 87. Let's watch for him.
Third down play for Navy. Third down and four. Tom Tarquinio, the sophomore quarterback. And this is Callahan on the end around, the wide receiver around. Not enough for a first down. Good defensive play for the Houston Cougars by linebacker Steve Bradham, number one, and cornerback Donnie Love. Twice the Navy has tried that play, Al. It hasn't worked so far.
No, it hasn't. They're playing it inside, and the way those defensive linemen and linebackers are playing, it's going to be awfully tough to make that play go.
Fourth down and two to go, and timeout is being taken by Navy. Timeout being called by Navy. Houston leading 14-0, 11:05 left to play in the second quarter, and we'll be coming right back after these messages from your local station. And handling the ball is Hubert Miller, the tight end, number 82. Hubert Miller came wide open in the middle, and that was a play that Bill Yeoman hoped to get going today.
Kind of interesting. Here's the Houston team. When they had the win, they ran the ball. Now that they're going against the win, they're throwing the ball and throwing it very well. It's a good football team.
Hell of a surprise, huh, Al?
It sure is.
First down for Houston. They lead 14-0. We're in the second quarter. What a halftime show coming up here today. The military on hand. We watched the rehearsal, and you're going to really enjoy it. So Houston, first down now on the Navy 41-yard line. Senior Terry Elston, who suffered a wrist injury earlier in the year, handing off to Terrell Clark, the tailback, and that will get very little, about a yard, and then he is stopped by co-captain Terry Huxel, number 54, out of Cincinnati, Ohio.
And every time you see Terry Elston make that kind of a spin, reverse kind of a pivot, he's coming to the outside, and the Navy team is closing the middle. It must be very tempting for Terry to think, let me pull it down and run it.
George Wells pacing the sidelines. Hubert Miller and Mark Ford, the tight ends, are the messengers. They alternate plays, bring the plays in from Bill Young. And this is second down and eight for Houston on the Navy 39-yard line. Terrell Clark, the tailback. And Terrell Clark goes across the 35 to about the 34-yard line. Mike Kronzer, number 63, outstanding Navy linebacker, helped by Mike Rouser, the defensive end, number 84. Third down and three now for the Houston Cougars at the Navy 34 and a half.
And a very big, big play for this Navy defensive team.
Linnell Fee, the wide receiver, to the near side, and Eric Herring to the far side. It is third and three. Terrell Clark and David Barrett are the setbacks in the drill. That's Barrett, the fullback, over the 30. First down, he's a hard-running ball carrier, and he has more than a first down before Mike Kronzer can get him down at about the 27-yard line.
You know, being a linebacker is very tough. Kronzer is a good one, but this man gets to him so quickly. Now that offensive line moves across, and before you know it, that back is right up on you. Look at that. That's offensive line play at its best.
And it's first and 10, Houston leading 14-0, second quarter of the third annual Garden State Bowl game. Terry Elston is the senior quarterback, having a very good day so far. Terrell Clark is the tailback, and that offensive line really keeps moving forward. They're doing quite a job. And of course, they'll bring it back to the progress. Mike Rouser of Navy and John Ross of Navy. Not giving easily on it. It goes to the 22-yard line.
No, they're not giving easily, but you know the strategy here, I think, is absolutely excellent on the part of Bill Yeoman. He's going to attack the middle guard and those two linebackers. The linebackers are both the leading tacklers on this Navy team, so he's going to run right at them. They're playing a bit off the line of scrimmage.
John Newhouse has come in at fullback for the first time this afternoon. It is Houston's second down and five. Newhouse is number 28, trailing Elston, the quarterback, finally knocked out of bounds at about the 15-yard line.
Another excellent call. The Navy team was playing an odd man to the left, to the top of your screen. The Houston team comes to the weak side and ran very effectively. You know, one good thing about a receiver, it's good to have speed, and it's good to be able to catch, but it's also good to try to block.
First down, Houston. Dave Barrett comes back in, replacing John Newhouse at fullback. First and 10, Houston on the Navy 15-yard line. Barrett, the fullback, number 18, may score a touchdown. And David Barrett goes 15 yards for a Houston touchdown. The Cougars have gone out in front by a score of 20-0. And this is an awesome show being put on by the Cougars. This time they drove it 69 yards to score.
And once again, they're hitting very quickly. Now again, they're coming back to that weak side. He's going to spin. He's going to hand off. Barrett is going to be taking this ball, going at full tilt. There's the hole, and he's off and gone.
Jeff Schaefer will try the point after touchdown. Jeff is 2 for 2, kicking for the first time this year. David Humphreys, the regular kicker, did not make the trip to the Garden State Bowl.
Keep in mind, the Navy team is ranked well up there defensively, and they've already given up 21 points.
And this time, the barefooted kicker from Klein, Texas, is a little off the target. And
points.
So, with 7:51 to play in the first half of the football game, Houston has gone ahead of Navy by a score of 20-0, and we'll be coming right back.
Take it easy. You know, I was known for working long and hard during training camp. Why, even after my teammates were asleep, I'd still be out practicing my moves, and that's still important. So I drink light beer from Miller. Light tastes great. It's got a third less calories than a regular beer, and the best thing is it's less filling. Because, listen, I still train the same way as the old days. Practice, practice, practice.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
Promotional consideration furnished by Champion Products, makers of fine athletic uniforms, exciting campus sportswear, and imprinted leisure wear. Across America and around the world, it takes a little more to make a champion.
We got 1, 2, 3. The Houston Cougars surprising the crowd here at the Garden State Bowl against one of the best defensive college football teams in America. The Cougars now have a 20-0 lead. They drove 69 yards in 9 plays. Fullback David Barrett, a junior, scored from 15 yards out. And now for Navy, John Ross and Dwayne Flowers take the deep drop. Ross is number 31 and Flowers number 25. And the barefoot kicker, Jeff Schaefer, will be putting it in play. We have a windy afternoon, and they have to hold the ball. That wind is out of the northwest at about 15 to 20 miles per hour. Navy's John Ross, number 31, starting from his 5. To the 20, Ross fighting. Loose ball, and it's been turned over. And the Cougars have a first down on the 25-yard line. And so Navy Al has turned it over.
Let's take another look at that touchdown. Here's Elston handing off. You're going to see Terry Huxel coming into the play. Doesn't quite get to the hole, number 54. And Barrett is just driving. They may hold the football in the wrong arm, but they sure know where that goal line is.
So Houston in position now to really take a wide lead in the football game. They have been cashing in the turnovers. It is first down, Houston, on the 25. Terrell Clark, who may get 100 yards in the first half, is the ball carrier. Terrell Clark may score a touchdown. And Clark goes in, a 25-and-a-half-yard run on first down and 10 for a Houston touchdown. And that'll put Terrell Clark very close to 100 yards rushing. And we are not even close to the first half of the football game.
Are they sure this is the number 2 team in the Southwestern Conference, Bob?
Well, this is a team that can be so outstanding on a given day.
Absolutely. They have some incredible runners. Now, this man isn't all that far. Clark isn't that far from a 1,000-yard rushing himself. He needs an awfully big day, but the start he's got, he may get it.
Well, they used only one play to score, and now Jeff Schaefer. No, I believe Schaefer will stay on the sideline. They missed on the last one out. I think they're going to try for 2. And so the Cougars now in front 26-0. We'll be trying for a 2-point conversion.
Let's take a look at this from the end zone, and you're going to see the speed of it. Look at that beautiful block on Huxel by the center. Excellent block, a great trap by their All-American, Finnell. And here he comes, Clark. Notice his shoulders are straight ahead, going for the goal line.
Terrell Clark now has 90 yards in the first half on 15 carries. As you point out, Al, he came into the game with 8:59. He's now at 9:49. He could very He might get to 1,000 here this afternoon.
Isn't that something? We thought it was going to be Eddie Myers with 957 coming in, and Eddie's out of the football game now.
Terrell Clark and David Barrett are the setbacks in the beer as Houston tries for the two-point conversion. Terry Elston having a brilliant first half as the quarterback. Here comes Elston running the other way. Elston will try to take it into the end zone, and he does. A two-point conversion by the quarterback, Terry Elston.
Let's remind you, this team of Navy beat the Rose Bowl team of Washington this year and beat them rather well.
And Houston now is out in front 28-0, 7:38 to go in the first half of the football game. It will be coming.
Don't find out about your homeowner's insurance by accident.
Hello, it's a recording, Stanley.
With a piece of the rock.
Hello, Prudential.
Our survey shows that even after a claim, people claim we're good.
We're covered? Oh, it's still a recording, Stanley.
For homeowner's insurance, too.
Give a piece of the rock.
Prudential Insurance. Even after a claim, people claim we're good.
Thanks, Prudential. She's talking to a human, Stanley.
Flight operations, Hawaiian Islands.
155 is the go bird.
10 degrees, right, runner.
Bring up 155 on number 2 elevator.
Cloud top to 28,000 feet.
Alpha Hotel, your wind is down the deck at 28.9.
The Navy. Over 75% of our jobs give you technical training. Get one.
Launch aircraft.
And clear.
Speak to your local recruiter or call this toll-free number. Navy. It's not just a job. It's an adventure.
The William Berry Game Jack, fashionable yet sturdy enough to stand nature's greatest wrath. The William Berry Game Jack, when it's man against nature.
28-0, Houston leading Navy. We're still in the first half of the football game. Navy spent the first half running back kickoffs. Flowers, number 25, juggles for a moment. Now the 28, 25, running well. Out over the 30 and to about the 34-yard line. Good return by Dwayne Flowers of the Midshipmen.
Dwayne Flowers on the return. Tackle was made by Calvin Easton.
One of the tough things, and this is a man with great speed. Weedy Harris is his name, number 51. Excellent. We'll probably see a great deal more of him today, but it's an interesting life playing on this kind of a team. You get hit by everybody but the referee.
Navy first down, their own 32-yard line. They'd love to prove they can score here in the first half of the football game. Sherlock is back in as tailback. Mike, number 23, comes out of the 35 to about the 36-yard line, and that's all that he can get. Greg Harmon made the stop at that point.
It would look to me, if Navy's going to continue to run this football, they're going to have to hit it quicker. You get those big defensive linemen to control that line of scrimmage, and your tailback is never going to move it. So Tolbert, number 30, is going to be the man that's going to have to carry the load if Navy's going to move.
George Wells is going with his sophomore quarterback, Tom Tarquinio, who's the best passer among the quarterbacking corps because he is behind in the football game 28-0. The pitch to Sherlock. Sherlock, the tailback, taken out of bounds across the way by Leo Truss, number 49, a junior defensive end from Lincoln, Alabama.
When you don't have a passing game, and we're seeing that today, a passing game with great speed at the outside, that defense is going to be playing you very tight. You're seeing a Houston Cougar team playing at the line of scrimmage virtually with an 11-man line. They're back, but they're all playing the run.
Dave Dent is a wide receiver toward the bottom of the screen. Running from the eye, and Navy with Sherlock, the tailback, going toward the far side. And again, number 44, Greg Harmon, doing beautiful pursuit for the Cougar defense. Third and long for the Midshipmen. This is a Navy football team that won 8 out of 11 football games. 24-10, and I think we have a face mask penalty coming up against the Houston Cougars. Here's the referee, C.C. Daly.
Face mask, defense, first down.
First down, Navy at midfield after the face mask call.
Let's see if they come with Tolbert now. The handoff, the quick handoff right up the middle, trying to beat Jose Taylor.
Kevin Tolbert is the fullback. He's the short back in the eye, number 30. Mike Sherlock, number 23, is the tailback. Eddie Myers was injured early in the game. He has not been back in. Tarquinio, the quarterback, is throwing, and it's incomplete for Kurt Gaynor, number 87, the tight end. Larry Curry, the strong safety of the Cougars, doing excellent defensive work.
That moving pocket is an effective offensive maneuver. However, there is, when you move to the left or to the right, that defense is going to be moving with you. You're generally throwing into a crowd. The shotgun, we know the Navy has shotgun. We may see that a bit later.
I think we will, Al. It is now second down and 10. The tight end Gaynor is the man moving over and resetting. Now this is second down and 10. Tarquinio to Sherlock, the tailback. Sherlock about a yard, maybe two, that's all. Hosea Taylor, the nose guard, number 90. What a player.
90 playing that nose guard, reluctantly moved to the middle. Now remember, he has a 45-pound weight edge on the center. Just kind of shoves him off and moves in across the line of scrimmage and makes the play. He's a big one. You're going to have to get there quickly. You can't beat him with anything slow getting to the line of scrimmage.
Third and 9 for the midshipmen. The ball at midfield. 28-0. Navy trailing late now in the second quarter. Tarquinio, the sophomore. Oh, it's batted by Harmon. He grabs it out of the air. Greg Harmon batted it, and now he can't hold on to it. And the ball is claimed by Kevin Tolbert, number 30 of Navy. Batted into the air by Harmon, number 44 of Houston.
Here comes that defense, and they're going to be barreling in on you. Hands are going to go up. That's Leonard Mitchell, 6'7", 271, 280 pounds. Those linemen run so beautifully.
It had been blown dead, and so Harmon has the interception. Batted it into the air, then he caught it. And it's going to be Houston first down on the 35 and another turnover against the midshipmen. They turned it over only about 1.5 per game all year long, and they've turned it over three times here in the first half. Terrell Clark, the tailback, goes for about 7 across the 30 to the 28-yard line.
More holiday viewing for the Mizlou Television Network coming up before the year is out. The Hall of Fame Bowl at Legion Field, Birmingham, Alabama. The Green Wave of Tulane and Lou Holtz, Arkansas Razorbacks. 8 o'clock Eastern time over most of these Mizlou Television Network stations.
And Howard, Terrell Clark of the Cougars is now over 100 yards rushing, and we have 5 minutes to play in the first half of the football game. Second and 2 right here for the Cougars, already with a 4-touchdown lead. Terrell Clark handing the ball, taking the handoff, and this time Navy is set and ready as Mitch Rushing joins with Paul Soares in making the tackle.
Bill Yeoman said his Rice team was embarrassed. His Houston team was embarrassed against Rice when they lost 35-7. He said they want very much to make a big showing here today, and you can't get much better than they are right now.
Houston, in 5 years in the Southwest Conference under Bill Yeoman, has won 30 and lost only 10 in conference play. Elston pitching back, this time to David Barrett, the fullback, number 18, and a good hit by Jeff Shoemake and John Ross of Navy. There's Dave Barrett, number 18, who has one of the touchdowns here in the first half.
They haven't gone up top to Lionel Fee, number 15. We said earlier he can fly. Now, they could possibly be setting that up. That was the safety man who made the tackle at the line of scrimmage.
Fourth down, less than a yard to go, Houston, on the 25-and-a-half-yard line of Navy. Looking at the Navy defense, this is fourth down and only about a foot to go for a first down. Terry Elston, the quarterback, gets a first down. Well, Elston, the quarterback, goes for the first and 10. And Houston, deep now in Navy territory at about the 23.
Bob, I'd have to give that first down to Randy Swisher, Fanio, Grimes, and that entire Houston offensive line. They really moved off the ball on that one.
Coach Bill Yeoman believes that his sophomore offensive right tackle, Maceo Pfeiffer, number 78, who weighs 274, might, before he's through, be the best offensive tackle he has ever had. That's how much he thinks of his play. First and 10 for Houston. Elston to Dave Barrett, and across the 20 to the 19-yard line. Good tackle made by Mitch Rushing, who's in as a linebacker now for Navy, along with Mike Kronzer. Rushing coming in as a middle guard, being helped by Mike Kronzer in making the tackle. The ball is on the 19-yard line. It's second down and 8.
You notice the adjustment that the Navy team made, really to take away the run of Houston to the right, force Houston to go back to the left. Right now, they're in, the Navy team isn't playing it straight up, the 5-2 kind of defense.
Second down and 8 for the Cougars. They're on the 19 of Navy. Terrell Clark, the tailback, penalty flags are thrown. He gets about two, then is smothered by Navy. The charge led by Mike Rouser, and we'll check out the penalty. The referee, C.C. Daly, will be posting the penalty for us in a moment. He talks with Navy's Mike Kranzer. Kranzer, number 63.
Illegal procedure. Six men on line. Offense. Decline. Third down.
Illegal procedure against Houston declined by Navy as we watch George Welch.
You know, as I watch George Welch and think about the great game he had in 1955 in the Sugar Bowl when he threw that football all over the field, I think he's wishing he had a passer.
He has done such a beautiful job of rebuilding the Navy football program.
He sure
3
has.
Years ago, they were 9-3. Last year, 7-4. They are 8-3 this year. These two teams, Houston and Navy, two of the finest college teams in America over the last 5 years. The reverse. Eric Herring, number 21, to the 15, and then hit down on about the 14. Herring, the flanker, back on a reverse, the ball carrier, and the tackle made by Navy's John Ross, number 31. Time remaining in the first half, 2 minutes and 33 seconds. This is our third annual Garden State Bowl. The first annual Garden State Bowl, it was Arizona State and Rutgers. Last year, Temple upset California. And we have a good crowd here this afternoon for the third game, the only bowl game in the Northeast. And the weather each of the 3 years has been good. This is the coldest of the three, and it's about 33 degrees. Last year, it was up around 45. And the year before, some 55 degrees. And I believe we'll have a timeout taken by the Houston Cougars. No delay of the game. They took too much time, so it'll be a five-yard step-off against the Houston Cougars.
Offensive team.
Time remaining in the first
fourth
half
down.
Now is 2 minutes and 6 seconds. You'll love the halftime show here today. It's a military show bringing together not only the midshipmen of Navy, but our military men from around this area, Alan. We were watching the rehearsal. It was a beautiful show. Field goal try by Jeff Schaefer, the barefooted kicker. The ball down at the 26. It must travel 36. It may do it. Jeff Schaefer, no, it is wide. Jeff Schaefer misses wide to the left, and so the ball goes over to Navy, and the field goal attempt is wide. It will be Navy starting first and 10 now from their own 20-yard line with a minute 44 to play in the first half. Al DeRogatis, I'm hoping that Eddie Myers of Navy will be able to return to this football game in the second half.
He did walk off the field. If he's hurt, he takes so much away from this Navy offense.
They have Mike Sherlock at tailback. Tom Tarquinio, the sophomore, is in at quarterback. Kevin Tolbert is the fullback. This is Sherlock, number 23. Good running tailback, comes out to the 25, to the 26-yard line. Second and four for the midshipmen. Houston 6-5 on the regular season, 5-3 in the Southwest Conference. They finished tied for second. Five members of the Southwest Conference are playing in postseason bowl games.
Once again, those three interior defensive men are controlling the line of scrimmage. You have to hit them quickly, but they're looking for an inside run now.
Second down and four, Tarquinio to Tolbert, the fullback, and out to the 30. That is a quick hitter for a first down.
That's the one. They're so big that you have to hit it. You try to contain them, get the tackle, the center, the guards, to contain those people, and then try to blow by them.
We look at Bill Yeoman, his 19th year as the head coach at the University of Houston. His teams have won 131, lost only 70, and six ties. Fourth Navy first down. Houston has racked up 11 here in the first half of the football game. And this is Tolbert, the fullback, once again doing a job into the secondary. Almost 10 yards up to the 40-yard line.
Okay, now that's the kind of thing, Bob, I've been talking about. Hit up there, pop. Get to the line of scrimmage as quickly as possible. And Tolbert, by the way, he also has a 4.7 average, as you know, Bob.
He's 5'9", weighs 221. He is a senior from Hempstead, New York. A first and 10 for Navy. They have only 32 seconds to try to get on the scoreboard here in the first half. Houston leading by a score of 28-0. Steve Bradham, co-captain and linebacker for the Cougars, comes to the sideline.
Now we could look again. The play action really could set up very nicely here. We might see young Tom try to take it deep, fake the handoff to Tolbert. The thing he doesn't have is the brilliant speed to the outside. And that 32 seconds may not be enough time.
It has been a brilliant first half for tailback Terrell Clark of the Houston Cougars, who came into the game with 849 yards on the season and has 100 yards here in the first half of the football game.
You don't think, do you, Bob, that Bill Yeoman re-watched that Army-Navy game?
He loves it.
I know he loves it, but he also saw the score.
Bill Yeoman was an All-American at West Point, played for Earl Blake.
Yes, he did. What a delightful afternoon Bob Murphy and I spent with Bill Yeoman yesterday. He's a great, great coach.
The Houston football entourage has certainly enjoyed their stay in New Jersey. Dave Dent, number 86, is a wide receiver for Navy. It is first down and 10, as we mentioned, only 32 seconds left. Navy with the ball at their own 41, Tarquinio for Dave Dent, number 86. And knocked out of bounds by Curry, number 48, the strong safety from Teague, Texas. So he got out of bounds to stop the clock. 26 seconds to play in the half. That's Dave Dent, the wide receiver for Navy, who caught 20 for 274 yards during the season.
Now, when you throw that kind of a pass to the side of the tight end, there is a tendency now for Houston to be looking for something like that. Gainer, again, good short. He's not a great speed man, but he can hurt you short.
Dent and Papajohn are the wide receivers. The ball in the 49 of Houston. Now here comes Dent in motion. Tom Tarquinio, the sophomore quarterback, throws intended and incomplete. Intended for Dent. Well covered by Donnie Love, the cornerback, number 35 of the Cougars. 21 seconds now left in the first half. Houston out in front by a score of 28 to nothing. They scored twice in the first quarter and twice here in the second quarter. Terrell Clark, Terry Elston, David Barrett, and Terrell Clark again. So Clark has scored twice and rushed for about 100 yards here in the first half. A little bit over 100. This is third and one for the midshipmen. Tom Tarquinio will throw on third and one. It's batted into the air and incomplete. Almost intercepted. Beautiful try for the Cougars, and they have really been doing a job of batting that ball away. That was Calvin Eason, number 38, who made the dive for it.
Bob, that's kind of the inexperience, really, of Tarquinio, because it looked like Gaynor, had he hesitated just a moment with a little bit more finesse, he could have gotten it over those two people, but he kind of forced it.
And this is fourth down. Less than a yard to go, 16 seconds to play in the first half, and the ball in the 49 of Houston. Tarquinio throwing on fourth and one. He's throwing long. It is over the head of Dave Dent, the split end, the intended receiver. And the ball goes over to Houston with only 9 seconds left in the first half. It has been a first half that has seen Navy turn the ball over and seen Houston take advantage of every opportunity. And the first half, Al, certainly has been dominated by the Cougars.
Well, you know, when a football game starts with turnovers, you never really expect it to be something like we didn't expect it to be the kind of game we're seeing right now, because, frankly, that defensive Navy is tough. But, goodness, that offensive Houston is awesome.
Turnovers can wreck you.
Yes, it does.
Houston was intercepted 6 times, so they lost their final game of the year to Rice, 35-7. 9 seconds left in the first half. Terry Elston is looking to throw. He is throwing way downfield for Linnell Fee. It is incomplete. Fee, number 15, was down on the 3-yard line, trying to get under it, and it was broken up beautifully by John Ross of Navy at the very last moment.
Well, you know, Fee really had him by about 3 or 4 yards. John made a super play, but that man would have outrun the football, I'll tell you. Elston could have thrown it as far as he wanted to, and he wasn't going to get it past Fee.
Linnell Fee, a game breaker, a very exciting football player with great speed. Now we get ready for the last play of the first half. 3 seconds left. Houston with a 28-0 lead. They have the ball on their own 49-yard line. Linnell Fee, the speedster, wind up wide to the near side of the field. Eric Herring toward the far side. Terry Elston will put it up again. Now he has to run. How far can he go? To the 40. And down on the 35-yard line as time runs out in the first half of the game. And so in our third annual Garden State Bowl game, at the half, it is Houston 28 and Navy nothing. We'll be back with the halftime ceremonies in a moment.
American cars used to be fat.
Now they're skinny.
Oil filters were fat too.
Then they went on a diet. But little engines run fast. They've got high piston speeds.
So it's really important to look after your car right.
Change the oil and put in a new Fram filter when you're supposed to.
A Fram filter doesn't cost much.
A new engine does.
But the choice is yours.
You can pay us now or pay us later.
Can't breathe.
You didn't take your contact, did you?
No.
And you were going to work today. That's my man. Keep going.
Charge.
You choose. Label says take this, but only when you stay home. Take this and you'll need six for just today.
Six?
Or take this one little contact.
That settles it. But what's this improved?
That's good. Means you'll get all their decongestant without their pain and cough things.
I'll phone you from the office.
Contact is the keeps you going cold medicine.
Hello.
Bic versus track two. Who's kidding who?
You're testing Bic against track two. Good luck.
Bic against track two? I can tell the difference blindfolded.
The results of the Bic barber test surprised a lot of people. 58% found Bic shave equal to or better than track twos.
I can't tell them apart.
Bic, I'm impressed.
Bic, I apologize.
Most men we tested felt
no difference.
And the price?
Big difference.
The incredible Bic, still under a quarter.
Let's pause for local station identification. This is Television Sports USA, the Mizlou Television Network. This.
Yeah.
What? Maybe my ears are cold.
Well, I can't help that.
Tape on my back.
Right.
They didn't bring a watch or anything, but we're at halftime of the Garden State Bowl here at Giant Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey, where the score at halftime is 28-0. Houston is leading Navy in really a shocker. Phil Davies is the account executive with Citizen. He'll be joining us in just a couple of moments. Earlier, prior to the telecast, as a matter of fact, I had an opportunity to speak with the governor of the state of New Jersey, the Honorable Brendan Byrne. We're at halftime of the Garden State Bowl, and for the third straight year, I have the privilege and pleasure of introducing to you the governor of the state of New Jersey, Brendan Byrne. Governor, it's good to see you. 3 years in a row, and for 3 years, you've produced some good weather. You have connections.
Howard, it's nice to be here. I take the blame for everything that goes wrong in the state, so I'm going to take the credit for this great weather and the great game we're seeing here in New Jersey this afternoon.
New Jersey, much maligned in a lot of areas. We can't hide that fact. But yet, the great things that are happening in New Jersey, most people are not even aware of that are not from the state. The airport at Newark Airport, as an example, it's so easy to get to, easy to leave from. It's just a tremendous airport, very convenient.
Well, New Jersey's ideally located, always has been, close to the markets. And frankly, the fact that the transportation now has become a very expensive component in any merchandising, and the fact that New Jersey has this tremendous advantage of being in the hub of a transportation center, gives us an increasing advantage. And more people finding out about Newark Airport, about New Jersey, and about what we've got going for us.
A year ago, we talked about the arena that was to open. It will open in a few months, and it'll house the New Jersey Nets and hopefully a hockey franchise.
That arena will be completed by June. We've got a great many exciting attractions ready to move in. The Nets will play their schedule next year there. We think we'll have a hockey franchise within a year playing in the arena. And I think you'll find, as people say, that this is the finest sports complex in the world, that the arena will live up to that reputation and indeed exceed it.
One of the most controversial decisions that was handed down, I guess, over the years has been the introduction of casino gambling in New Jersey, and it's been very successful.
Casino gambling has been. We picked an ideal site for it. Atlantic City was the queen of resorts, is going to be again. And the fact is that the people are going to Atlantic City and will continue to go, not just to visit a casino, but because this is a great resort city. It's got a great climate, the finest beaches, and a great many other things that you can do in Atlantic City to have a first-class vacation or a first-class convention. We're bringing all the governors into Atlantic City next August for the National Governors Conference.
You're not partisan to the University of Houston, are you, with this hat?
No, the University of Houston made this presentation. I'm an honorary Texan for the day, but I'm trying to be impartial out there.
Well, you're doing a great job, and we look forward to seeing you again, and you might have my job next year.
No, I don't think so, Howard. You're doing very well.
Thank you.
More halftime festivities at the Garden State Ball after these words from your local stations.
Do I?
No.
Yeah, I hear it, but it's very faint.
Part of the Marine Band here at halftime of the Garden State Bowl, and a military halftime tribute to all of the services. And as I mentioned earlier at the top of the halftime, I have Phil Davies, who is an account executive with the Citizens Watch Company. Phil, we're delighted to have you with us. Citizens, of course, the official timepiece of the Mizlou Television Network. And you have braved the cold to come out with us today. We appreciate that.
I thank you very much. Citizen Watch Company of America is very, very proud to be part again of the third annual Garden State Bowl, Howard.
Phil, I got to tell you something. I was down in Nassau about two or three weeks ago, and it's a whole lot warmer down there than it is up here. I walked into the store, and the whole joint was loaded with Citizen signs. Why? I thought you were down there with your signs beforehand.
Unfortunately, they have me assigned up here where it's cold, Howard.
We appreciate Citizens' involvement. We appreciate you coming by, and hopefully you'll be with us for a long time to come.
Absolutely. We tend to be on it every year from now on. We hope the players will be very proud of the watches we've given to them, and our sponsorship and participation is very important to us.
Phil Davies, account executive with the Citizens Watch Company, the official timepiece of the Mizlou Television Network. Thank you.
On the field right now at the Garden State Bowl at Giant Stadium, the great Houston Band, numbering in the over 150 strong. Halftime of the Garden State Bowl here at Giant Stadium, East Rutherford, New Jersey. This gentleman is the Chief Executive Officer of the New Jersey Sports and Exposition Authority, Robert Mulcahy. In 3 years, you have seen tremendous growth in the bowl.
Absolutely, Howard. We're delighted today. We'd like the score to be a little closer, but everything else with the game is terrific. It's been our best year ever.
I would imagine if I were an alum of Navy or a fan of Navy, I would not be too delighted with the score, number one. Number two, I would not be too delighted with already down 28 to nothing and watching Houston throwing a bomb looking to make it 35 to nothing going to the locker room.
Well, I think that Navy knows they have a tough road to hoe. Houston's playing like the team that we thought they were, that they were rated in the top 20 before the season began, and have really put on an awesome performance here today.
You could have done a little bit better so far as the weather is concerned, Bob. I don't like wearing a coat while I work.
Well, if the sun's shining, the temperature's in the mid-30s, and at this time of year, we're happy with it.
Bowl planning for 1981 will get underway tomorrow, I would imagine.
Absolutely.
Which means that you have to start looking at putting together the committee all over again, and everything starts all over again, or at least parts of the committee anyway.
Well, we have a great committee. They've done a great job, and we've trained some people to move into it. We also, I would like to give a little praise here to both schools. They've been terrific to work with. Everything they've done here has been first class, and we've been delighted that they've been visitors here this week.
Bob, thanks for coming up here at halftime. I know you're very busy during the bowl, and we wish you lots of luck in the future.
Thank you, Howard, and good luck to all our other fellow bowl people across the country for their bowls. Thank you.
More halftime festivities at the Garden State Bowl after this word from your local station.
Featuring all of our Cougar show team, this is the finale from Overture 18.
Halftime of the Garden State ball at Giant Stadium, 28-0. Houston leading the midshipmen of Annapolis. And the theme of the halftime is a salute to the armed services. Well represented today. Promotional consideration paid for and provided by Turtle Extra Car Wax. Extra polymers and silicones make it extra long-lasting, extra brilliant, and extra easy. Turtle Extra Car Wax in liquid and soft paste. Today's your Brute Day. Great days seem to happen more often when you're wearing Brute by Fabergé. After shave, after shampoo, after anything, Brute by Fabergé.
Come to Mama Leone's, where the family can sit around the table, tell those old stories and maybe some new ones. Mama Leone's, where the fun and food never stop.
The second half of today's Garden State Bowl is brought to you by the 1981 Volkswagens. A salute to the armed forces at halftime of the Garden State Bowl here at Giant Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey.
I was born on July 4th, 1776. The Declaration of Independence is my birth certificate. I am 200 million living souls and the ghosts of millions who have lived and died for me. I stood at Lexington and fired the shot heard round the world. I am George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, Patrick Henry. I am Lee and Grant, Abe Lincoln and John Kennedy. I am General Pershing, General Arnold, and General Eisenhower. I left my heroes dead in Flanders Field, on a lot of Corregidor, on the slopes of Korea, and in the steaming jungles of Vietnam. I am big. I am forest, field, mountain, and desert. I am quiet villages and cities that never sleep. Yes, I am the nation. And these are the things that I am. I was conceived in freedom, and God willing, in freedom, I will spend the rest of my days. May I possess all the courage and the strength and the integrity to keep myself unshackled, to remain a citadel of freedom and a beacon of hope to the world. May we all, here and now, reaffirm our undying allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, with liberty and justice for all.
There's no such thing as an average citizen. Each one is different, each one you can trust. There's no such thing as an average citizen. For Citizen Watch, innovation's a must.
Combining elegance and precision, the anything but average ladies' dress quartz from Citizen, designers of the first quartz movement to break the 1 millimeter barrier.
There's no such thing as an average citizen.
College football is a uniquely American game. From the first contest more than 100 years ago to the present day, no game more reflects the fabric of American society. Hello, everybody. This is Keith Jackson. And now there is a place which brings the rich history of college football right to you. The new College Football Hall of Fame at Kings Island, Ohio, on Interstate 71 just north of Cincinnati. It's a piece of Americana you should see.
We're getting ready to start the third quarter here at Giant Stadium at East Rutherford. 28-0 Houston leads Navy as we present the Sony first half highlights. And obviously the highlights were all Cougars. First of all, you get a look at David Barrett in the second quarter, already a 14-0 ball game, and a 14-yard run for David Barrett puts the Cougars on top 20-0 at that point. And the Navy was just about in the process of being sunk completely with a 20-0 Houston lead. Terrell Clark for the second time of the day scores a touchdown, this one 26 yards away after Houston had recovered a Navy fumble on the 26-yard line. This was a first down play. Terrell Clark, 26 yards for the score. Terry Elston then a two-point conversion. And it made it 28-0, which is where we stand as we get ready for the third quarter of this, the third annual Garden State Bowl football game. Coming up on Friday night over most of these Mizlou Television Network stations, the Holiday Bowl football game from San Diego, California. The SMU Mustangs and the Cougars of Brigham Young University do battle. And then on Saturday, the 20th, from the Tangerine Bowl in Orlando, Florida, the Terrapins of Maryland against the Gators of Florida. 27th of December, we bring you the Hall of Fame Bowl, Arkansas and Tulane. And on New Year's Eve, the New Year's Eve tradition, the Bluebonnet Bowl with the Longhorns of Texas and the Tar Heels of North Carolina. Bob Murphy, the statistics kind of bear out the score. 28-0, and Houston has completely dominated the football game.
Quite surprising, Howard, when you realize how well Navy has played all year long defensively, ranking as one of the outstanding college football teams on defense, number 5 in the nation in scoring defense, allowing only about 10 points a football game. And here are the Cougars with 28 points in the first half.
We have some more Mizlou magic coming up during 1981 in May and June, the best rodeo with the Cowboys and Cowgirls. That is a truly exciting event. Even the cold weather, Bob, doesn't deter the youngsters that come here all the way from the southwest part of the United States.
The weather for all three Garden State Bowl games has been good.
And I can't wait for this golf tournament because that means the warm weather's here. And I don't mind telling you, this bone-chilling cold didn't sit too well with me, and I've been from the north all my life. Well, this is the CPC Women's International Golf Tournament from Moss Creek Plantation in South Carolina. Some of the guys that make it possible for you to see these great pictures that we're seeing today are cameramen who don't get the credit they really deserve.
Boy, their camera work was just beautiful in the first half of the football game. Al DeRogatis was saying that the work with the interior linemen was some of the best he'd ever seen.
Well, for the first time in my life last year, I sent a letter to Mizlou to tell them and compliment them on the camera work. And again today, they did it. Nice going, man. You've just been super.
That fellow Santa Claus.
I thought Santa Claus had a white beard.
Well, he could always change that one a little bit. Speaking of the weather, I guess it was a factor as far as Bill Yeoman was concerned. He elected, after winning the coin toss, to have the wind and put his defense on the field. He had done the same thing against Texas Tech. Got out in front by 17. He gets out in front by 28 by doing it today.
There was some doubting Thomas's, Al, after the selection of Houston. At the time they were selected for this football game, they were 5-4 with still two football games to play. And there was the fingers crossed, I would imagine, with the Garden State Bowl selection committee with still two games to go, hoping they would do no worse than split their last two.
Well, you're right. And, you know, when you look at that last game against Rice, Bill Yeoman made the comment that in that game his team took a vacation, which was kind of surprising, and they really wanted to make it up here today. Keep in mind, I don't think it's going to happen here because the domination has really been rather overwhelming. That defensive line of Houston is very much intimidated. The entire running attack of the Navy team, but keep in mind that it was the same Houston team that led a Notre Dame team in the Cotton Bowl 34-12, only to end up losing 35-34. And I'm sure Bill Yeoman in that locker room just reminded the Cougars of that very game.
You can dip into the pro ranks a couple of weeks ago or a week ago. San Francisco and New Orleans, 35-7 at halftime. New Orleans is ahead. Looks like they're going to win their first ball game of the year, and they lose it in the second half.
This is so true. Well, you know, the passing attack is what makes the difference. And, you know, when George is going to have to go back, George Wells is going to have to go back to the things that Navy does well. He can't afford to start opening this thing up. He's going to grind. He's got to hope that, first of all, he can stop. And that he must do. He can stop Houston on his very first series and try to get that ball back quickly.
Al, I'm looking at the far sideline when we had the cameras showing the Navy football team, looking for number 40, Eddie Myers, who was hurt. The second time he carried the ball, did not come back onto the field. It'll be important to Navy if he can come back.
Well, there's no doubt about that. Now, that's a good runner there. Eddie Myers runs as well as anybody, and he's awfully strong inside. Now, if he's not in there, and Sherlock is not quite Eddie Myers. A good runner, but obviously not as good as Eddie Myers. Tolbert becomes the man that he's going to have to try to establish something with, try to keep the football on the ground, and try to grind it out. Hope to get a touchdown and get back into the football game.
Houston will receive, as we start the second half, at our third annual Garden State football game. Navy's Steve Fair, number 24, will be kicking off. Steve had a 50-yarder in the Navy win over Army. And under George Welch, Navy has won the big traditional game with Army 7 out of 8. Deep to receive for Houston will be Linnell Fee, number 15, and Jimmy Wright, number 86.
Both of them, Bob, run like 9.7, 9.6. We asked Bill Yeoman, well, why aren't they on the track team at Houston? He said, well, you can't believe the way the track team runs.
Jimmy Wright is a wide receiver, number 86, and of course so is Linnell Fee, one of the most exciting college receivers that you will see. And the second half is underway on the kick by Steve Fair. Linnell Fee, number 15 of Houston, will squirt free at the 25. It looked like he would be down, and he is pinned down on the 30-yard line for Navy, by Navy, by Mitch Rushing on the special teams, wearing number 60. And so the Cougars first down on their own 29-yard line. They just dominated the first half of the game in total offense. Houston had 226 yards and Navy just 77. And so Navy on defense as we start the third quarter.
In the beginning of the football game, when Houston got that break, they immediately attacked the center of that line. So again, the nose guard 56, the two linebackers, will they go after them? Yes, they are.
This is Terrell Clark, who had 112 yards in the first half of the football game. He now has about 116 yards. And we should point out, if Terrell Clark gets 151 yards in this game this afternoon, he will reach 1,000 for the season. Second and 5 for the Cougars, coached by Bill Yeoman. Bill, an All-American at Army, playing under Earl Blake, now in his 19th year as the very successful Houston head coach. Terry Elston, the senior, a tall, lanky, talented quarterback, directing the attack for Houston. Elston throws and broken up by John Ross, number 31. John Ross of Navy, number 31, broke it up. It was intended for Linnell Fee.
Now, it looks like an obvious passing situation, but as you look at this Navy defense, and we'll give you a shot of that, a wide shot, because they're playing it so very wide with the nose guard, the two defensive tackles are extremely wide, the linebackers are playing soft, a quick hitter up in there can make it go for that first down.
We'll watch Terry Elston now on third and five for the Cougars. They're on their own 34-yard line. Elston faking to Barrett, pitching to Terrell Clark. Clark the tailback, out over the 40, has a first down, out of bounds at about the 42-yard line.
Just another excellent call. That fake up the middle froze everybody. The linebackers froze. The pitch out gets out. A big play. Big third down.
And Terrell Clark is really putting together a sensational day. The Houston tailback from Galena Park. 5'7", 196 pounds. He started the day with 859 yards, and now he's up to about 125. First and 10 for Houston on their own 44-yard line. Terry Elston looks over the defense. The fullback, number 18, is David Barrett, and he's having a good day. Barrett comes almost to midfield, a pickup of about six, and he's tackled by Terry Hutzel.
Randy Swisher. An awfully good man with that football. Watch how he opens his hole. Moves off the ball, gets a good block. Now the left guard is going. He's turning his man. The man is hitting behind that. That's good offensive football.
Second and five. The Houston ground game with the beer is doing an outstanding job against what has been all year a very good Navy defense. Elston pitching now to Barrett, the fullback, number 18. And he goes for a first down over the 45 and all the way to the 41-yard line of Navy. Travis Wellington, the defensive left end, number 88. 48, helped out by Elliot Riggins, the defensive halfback.
Houston is so well prepared for this football game. They're playing it pretty much their way. They're hitting them inside, getting Navy to play tight. When Navy comes in tight, they take it to the outside. Excellent offensive calls.
They took the second half kickoff, started on their own 29-yard line. Now they have a first and 10 on the Navy 40-yard line. Early in the third quarter, Houston leading by a score of 28-0, trying for their seventh win of the season. Elston to Terrell Clark, the tailback. Not quite as much this time, maybe two or three. And a good defensive play by Paul Soares of Navy. Soares getting up along with number 69, linebacker Ted Dumball. Ted Dumball, number 69, 215-pound senior out of Troy, Ohio, calling the defensive signals. Unofficially, Terrell Clark of Houston now with 124 yards on 21 carries. And David Barrett, 60 yards on 9 carries. Second and 8. Elston spinning around, pitching back to Terrell Clark. And Clark will be hit down on the 32-yard line. Fine defensive work by linebacker Ted Dumball.
May have been the best defensive play of the day for the Navy team. They played that beautiful. They strung it out. They closed off the middle. They watched the pitch. And they moved to the outside. Excellent team defense. Watch the way they string this out. He had one option. Dumball's closing. The cornerback is coming up. Nice play all the way around. That was Bobbitt. Bobbitt is the rover.
Third and two, Houston on the Navy, 32-yard line. Early third quarter. And it will be given off again to Terrell Clark. He'll be very close to a first down. Downed on the 30. Co-captain Terry Huxel, number 54 of Navy, leading the charge along with Paul Soares, number 67. Not quite a first down. We have a report from the sideline that Eddie Myers is out with a rib injury. So here's the fourth down play for the Cougars. Fourth down, they need a half a foot. And every time today in that spot, Terry Elston, the quarterback, has gone for the first down.
Well, that means that Terry Elston is counting on Bobby Grimes, whom I like the way he's playing. Randy Swisher, who's moving off that ball extremely well, and Jack Fanio, number 65, their top offensive lineman.
Staying on the ground, except for one incompleted pass, Houston now has marched 41 yards. They've marched 41 yards. They have a first down on the midshipman 29-yard line. Senior quarterback Terry Elston, the man whose dramatic pass won the Cotton Bowl game a year ago, keeping it and being ridden out of bounds. About a yard beyond the line of scrimmage, and that is all. Jeff Shoemake, number 14, helped out by Mike Rouser.
Now, the thing the Navy team cannot do right now is be lulled to sleep. Now, they're thinking run, and they're playing it very tight. Now, we mentioned earlier about Lonel Fee, who can really go deep, but the other guy, number 21, Herring, is the man that has the finesse and can really hit the cracks. Far side of the field, number 21.
Second down and eight. And Eric Herring is flanked wide to the right, as pointed out. And Elston throws for Herring, number 21, and it's going to be incomplete. Riding him out of bounds is Elliot Reagans, number 47 of Navy.
Okay. Truthfully, he has good hands. He is the leading receiver. Again, short, most catches, not deep. Good move, takes it to the outside. He's wide open. That very vulnerable spot.
Third and eight now for Houston. A key play if they are to keep this drive alive. Hubert Miller brings the new play in, alternating at tight end with Mark Ford, who also does the punting. And the key man here is Terry Elston, the 6 foot 4 inch quarterback. Elston spins around and throws for his tight end, and a penalty flag is down. Jeff Shoemake made the tackle. Was made by Mark Ford.
It's going to be an interesting call now, because that could go either way. Jack Fania, we've been talking about, is, we think, an awfully good offensive guard. He's number 65. Now watch him go to the outside. That's a good block. You're going to give your passer all kind of time, and he moves out very well. That's well done.
And for the Cougars, then, it is first down, six, and goal to go. They have had the ball since the second half kickoff. They have driven from their own 29-yard line, and now it's first down, six, and goal to go.
He'll probably go straight up, but number seven likes to keep the ball himself down here.
Terrell Clark, and he does keep it himself, Al, and he'll take it to the 2-yard line. Good call by Al DeRogatis. He goes right to the two, tackled by Ted Dumball. Second down, 2 yards, and goal to go. Cougar offense can be so awesome. They call Bill Yeoman the father of the Veer. And he told us, Al, he more or less discovered it by trial and error, by just trying something new.
Old serendipity strikes again. It was the old, you remember, he said it was the 44 Veer and the 23 Veer. They used that terminology at Army. And he did pick it up by a kind of accident.
Terrell Clark, the tailback, fighting for the goal line. And he's over. Terrell Clark has scored for the third time this afternoon. Terrell Clark, the senior tailback from Galena Park, has scored for the third time. And so it is 34-0 in favor of the Cougars.
Interesting, Bob. Despite the 34 about to become 35-0, I can see why this Houston team could do it in either way. They've got so much talent, really. The kind of talent that they put it all together, they just blow you out of the ballpark.
Now Greg Harmon will hold. Jeff Schaefer has the kick on the way. Line drive kick. That is good. And so it is 35-0. The Cougars have taken the lead. And a big one at that in the third annual Garden State Bowl. We'll be coming right back.
Johnny Rutherford, that's some car you drive.
Yep.
Handles nice and tight, huh?
Yeah.
Accelerates like...
like a bull out of a chute. Not many pit stops, either.
You mean that Volkswagen Scirocco?
Sure. When it comes to driving on the street, my Scirocco even beats my Chaparral.
That's really something. A 3-time Indy winner drives a Volkswagen Scirocco S.
You bet. Nobody ever remembers who finished second.
Volkswagen does it again.
The Army can make you feel a lot of ways. Challenged, trained, and proud.
With this time, with these people, with this feeling, feeling good, feeling good.
Dropping deep to receive now for the Naval Academy will be Steve Callahan and Dwayne Flowers. Jeff Schaefer, the sophomore kicker from Klein, Texas, will be kicking off for the Houston Cougars. And here's the kick by Jeff Schaefer. At the 2-yard line, it will be Dwayne Flowers, number 25, who brings it back to the 25, to the 22-yard line, beg your pardon. And that's where Navy will start, first and 10 from their own 22. On the return, Dwayne Flowers, number 25 of the Midshipmen. Navy has gone without their outstanding running back, Eddie Meyer, since the second time he carried the ball very early in the football game. Tolbert is at fullback. Fred Reitzel is the quarterback.
That's the play.
Yes, Tolbert. It started to work for him right at the end of the first half. The quick hitter by the fullback, Kevin Tolbert.
Well, you know, when you're 6'5 and 265 and you're playing that nose guard, that center is simply going to try to contain you. 45 pounds he's outweighed by, but he's moving across the ball, and that back is hitting so quickly. Good call.
23 yards by senior fullback, Kevin Tolbert. Tolbert, number 30, and the tailback is Mike Sherlock, number 23. For Navy, first down from their own 45, and Reitzel puts it up. It is completed to the tight end, Kurt Gaynor, number 87 at midfield, and a stride over into Houston territory. Donnie Love was covering for the Cougars. Gain of 6 on the completed pass, second down and 4 for Navy. Fred Reitzel, the senior, is back in at quarterback. After Navy fell behind early in the second quarter, Tom Tarquinio, the passing sophomore, came in. Now Reitzel is back again. Reitzel still has it. Reitzel throwing incomplete, intended for Kurt Gaynor, the tight end, number 87. And again, Larry Curry, the strong safety, was over there, but that was overthrown.
Fight, dog!
Come on, Mitch! For the midshipmen, third and about 4 on the 49-yard line of Houston. 9:09 to play in the third quarter. The wide receiver is Dave Dent, number 86. That's Kurt Gaynor, the tight end, resetting. Fred Reitzel on this third and 4. Talbert, the fullback, getting very little. Not a first down by any means. Only about the line of scrimmage. Kelly McDonald, number 41, playing the defensive left end for the Cougars, made the stop. So it is fourth and long. And on the field to punt is Lex Lauletta for Navy. Lonel Fee is number 15, and he is the single safety, the punt return man, third best in the entire nation. An exciting football player. Lauletta will hit it from his own 41-yard line. He hit it beautifully. Lonel Fee takes it at his own 7-yard line, and he can get nowhere. The Navy special teams doing a big job. .822 left to play now in the third quarter. Houston out in front by a score of 35-0. And we'll be right back after these messages from your local station. Houston, first down on their own 9. Beautiful defensive work by the Navy special teams. And Brent Chin in the game for the first time, passing to Lonel Fee. He caught it, but he was out of bounds right there on the 19-yard line. Brent Chin in for the first time, the sophomore who came in beautifully behind Terry Elston many times earlier.
He's 6 foot tall. He weighs only 150 pounds, but he's awfully quick. So Navy team has to watch this man very closely. Here's the kind of thing where Navy, Bob, is playing it so tight that one of these backs can bust it for a very long run.
So on his very first play, Brent throws for a first down from the 19. Terrell Clark, the tailback, coming out over the 25 to the 26. And there he's tackled by Mike Rouser. So Terrell Clark is really closing in on 1,000 yards now. As we mentioned, he started the day with 859. He needs 141 to get to 1,000 here this afternoon. He now needs only five more yards out.
He's awfully good, awfully good. Now we want to watch these defensive ends, Wallington and Rubin, Mike Rubin, because it looks
second
like they might
for the Cougars. Brent Chin, the sophomore, is now in the ball game, and he gives off to Terrell Clark. Oh, he's over 1,000 right now as he comes out over the 40 and up to about the 44-yard line, taken by the safety, number 14, Jeff Schumick.
He's over 100 yards, I think, three times this year. The domination at the line of scrimmage, another great block at the line of scrimmage, a beautiful hole, and they bust it right up at you.
And Terrell Clark, after ripping that one for a first and 10 to the 45 and going over 1,000 for the year, comes to the sideline. John Newhouse is in at fullback right now. That's 151 yards for Terrell Clark on 25 rushes. Brent Chin rolling right. Chin throws for Eric Herring, number 21. And at the far sideline, they hook it up. And it goes to the 49-yard line of Navy. Covering was Chris Boblett. In the backfield for Houston now, it'll be Alan Polk, number 32, as the running back. And the fullback is the veteran, John Newhouse, number 28. The Cougars with a 35-0 lead. A surprising score at the expense of Navy. A team that was 8-3 during the regular season. The handoff will go to Alan Polk, number 32, who just came in at the tailback. Ken Fancher of Navy will make the stop, but it'll be a first down.
The fullback in there now is the cousin of the great Robert Newhouse from the Dallas Cowboys. And it's interesting, Bill Yeoman says this fella has fabulous talent. Whether he has the same intensity as his cousin is questionable, but we may find that out today.
Just a moment ago, Houston was back on their own 9-yard line. This is Newhouse, the cousin to Robert Newhouse, trying to slash his way over the right side, but he runs into Steve Chambers and Ken Fancher of Navy. The first annual Garden State Bowl, Arizona State and Rutgers. And then last year, Wayne Hardin's Temple Owls upset California, and it was an exciting football game. Number 15, Lonnell Fee. Might be the fastest player on the field here this afternoon. Second down and 7 for the Cougars on the Midshipman 42. Chin is the spinning quarterback, flipping it back now to Polk, number 32. Polk hit out of bounds. Good defensive play by the Rover back, Chris Boblett, number 34.
You know they're going to try Fee again, and probably pretty soon, too, because they came to his side. The quarterback's looking to see what that defensive secondary's doing. That fly pattern is always a possibility.
Next Friday night from San Diego Stadium, the Holiday Bowl. It'll be the Mustangs of SMU against Tom McMahon, the great passer, and BYU. Navy won the Holiday Bowl game 2 years ago. Chin to Alan Polk, number 32. That'll be another first down for the Cougars.
Bill Yeoman is now using the double tight end formation. He's just kind of driving it out of there. He's keeping it on the ground, eating up the clock. It's probably Bill's way of keeping the score down even more. Although the Houston team isn't thinking about that, Bob. They're going to roll it up if they can.
They are getting an awful lot of yardage in this football game today. Eric Herring is number 21, the wide receiver now for the Houston Cougars. On the near side, Linnell Fee, number 15. Brent Chin on a draw, gives this time to Newhouse, the fullback. Newhouse over the 30 to about the 27-yard line. Linebacker Mike Kronzer, what a busy day he is having. Makes the tackle for the midshipman. Second and 5. The tight ends are the messengers for Bill Yeoman. They alternate, bring the plays in, except in the situations where he goes to the two tight ends. First downs, Houston 20 and Navy 6. It has been a great day for the Cougar offense. Alan Polk, the tailback, number 32, has to be tugged down from behind across the 20-yard line by linebacker Mike Kronzer. The senior linebacker is really working it as hard as you can work.
He's the leading tackler, and when they get by the line of scrimmage, you begin to understand why he is, although this defense has been so good all year. great credit to the Houston offensive line. I just cannot say enough about them.
In this drive alone, Houston now has moved 70 yards. It is first and 10 on the 19. Brent Chen, the sophomore quarterback, throws, and Colonel Fee, number 15, completed on the 7 or the 8-yard line. Fee made the grab, took a real hard hit from Jeff Shoemaker. And a penalty flag thrown.
Yeah, the courage of a wide receiver is tested so often. But staying in bounds and knowing you're going to get popped is one of those unpleasant moments in football.
So the completed pass will be nullified. The penalty against Houston. Let's listen to the referee, C.C. Daly. Ineligible receiver.
Bob, the play I'm still waiting for is that reverse using number 15, Lonel Fee. He's tight to this side. Now, he's very tight to this side. This is a possibility.
First and 25, Houston will be watching for it. Alan Polk is the tailback, number 32. He'll be hit down on the 30-yard line. Mike Rouser, junior right in from Gaithersburg, Maryland, and co-captain Terry Huxell out of Cincinnati, Ohio, get together on the tackle. Time remaining in the third quarter here at the Garden State Bowl. The beautiful Giants Stadium in New Jersey. The time left in the third quarter is 3:48. You won't find a better looking football stadium anywhere in America than Giants Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. The scene of the Garden State Bowl. Newhouse, the fullback, slashing to about the 25-yard line. It'll be third down and long.
When you look at the Newhouse run, as they've been talking about more frequently now on television, they're looking at the way those shoulders are pointed. The shoulders are level, the shoulders are going straight ahead. That's the mark of a good running back, and he hits up there very quickly.
So now we'll keep an eye out for Lonel Fee, number 15, the wide receiver, because this is third down and 15 for Houston. Brent Chen, 165-pound quarterback, dropping the throw. He's looking for Fee, can't find him, now he's running. Still wants to throw it, does throw it off balance, it's up for grabs, and I believe taken at the 9-yard line by Chris Boblett, number 34. Chris Boblett of Navy intercepted the deflected pass. And so the ball will go over to the midshipmen, first and 10 on their own 9, and I believe Navy will call a timeout. Navy will call a timeout, and we'll be coming right back.
42.
Foul! Oh, what a call! What a heartburn. How do you spell relief?
Check the board, coach.
R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Rolaid spells relief. Unbeatable relief. Relief Tums can't beat. Relief no other leading antacid can beat.
For comic relief, I put on a frown. But for acid indigestion, I spell relief. R-O-L-A-I-D-S. Unbeatable.
Rolaid spells relief. Unbeatable relief.
Don't find out about your auto insurance by accident.
Ducks, ducks.
Forms, forms.
With a piece of the rock.
Hello, Prudential.
Our survey shows that even after a claim, people claim we're good.
I'm covered. Thanks, Prudential.
Ducks, forms, what ducks?
For auto insurance, too.
Get a piece of the rock.
Prudential Insurance. Even after a claim, people claim we're good.
Tell them. They go quack, quack.
Let's take a look at this now. This is the athlete that we were talking about. He can move. He's quick. He's not big, but he's terribly quick. That was a fine defensive play also. And here's Bobbitt. That's a drill you work on constantly.
Mike Sherlock, the midshipman tailback, taking the pitch, running wide, being chased out of bounds at the 15-yard line, a gain of about 6. Grady Turner, the junior linebacker out of Tyler, Texas, doing the work on defense.
I've seen this Kevin Tolbert a few times, and I've liked him every time I've seen him. He may be down, but he's fighting every single play.
He's 5'9", 221, as we look at that very happy Houston Cougar bench. Senior quarterback Fred Reitzel is throwing to Papajohn, the wingback completed. And a first down out at the Navy 30-yard line. Tackling was Steve Bradham, the co-captain and linebacker out of Longview.
We might keep our eye on those two linebackers now again for the Houston team, because they've been popping Tolbert pretty regularly, and the two linebackers should be looking for him coming up the middle.
Dent and Papajohn, the wide receivers. Reitzel throws. This is Papajohn once again fighting for yards and out of bounds on the 44-yard line. Knocked out by Donnie Love, number 35, the cornerback.
You're seeing a zone defense now in that Houston secondary, a deep zone. They're giving Navy really the short passes. They just don't want them to do anything deep.
Houston leading 35-0. Tailback Terrell Clark has scored three times and rushed for about 150 yards. Navy would like to get on the board. Reitzel, the senior quarterback, is throwing for Kirk Gaynor, the tight end. It was over his head and incomplete. Al Windham, number two, the free safety, was covering.
That's the old prevent defense. It's a three-man rush. The two defensive ends now become linebackers. You've got a 3-8 situation. You better have some awfully fast receivers if you're going to beat that.
Second down 10 for the Midshipmen. Late now in the third quarter here in the Garden State Bowl in beautiful Giants Stadium. Fred Reitzel is the senior quarterback. Dent and Papajohn both wide toward the top of your screen. Reitzel spinning around, Reitzel keeping, and Reitzel being hit down after a run of about two on the 46-yard line of Navy.
Weedy Harris is number 51. He's fast. He's going to move to the ball. He's watching that back that he's working on. Notice how that defensive line, rather, is controlling the line of scrimmage, and he moves beautifully to the ball. Nice play.
Weedy Harris, only a sophomore. Bill Yeoman looking forward to two more years of having him around. This is third and eight for Navy from their own 46-yard line. Fred Reitzel scrambling and throwing. Oh, it is incomplete. Oh! Larry Curry, the strong safety for the Cougars, number 48, hit it into the air, and it almost was picked off. Making a dive for it was Albert Windham. It'll be fourth down, and Navy will turn the ball over on a punt. Lex Lauletta comes on now to punt for Navy. Time left in the third quarter, a minute and 30. Lonel Fee is number 15, the speedster of the Houston Cougars. He takes the deep drop. Lex Lauletta, 41-yard punting average for Navy. Bob Murtha makes the long snap. It is a good one. Fair catch call for by Lonel Fee at the 25-yard line of Houston. And so the ball goes to Houston, first and 10 from their own 25-yard line. And we'll be coming right back with more of the action in the Garden State Bowl in just a moment.
We've made some major changes in the 1981 Volkswagen Rabbit.
You sure have. Where's the car?
We've made the engine bigger to give the Rabbit more power for passing.
Oh, boy, that must do wonders for your gas mileage.
As a matter of fact, our mileage is better this year.
But wait a minute. The engine is bigger and the mileage is better? How'd you do that?
Very well.
Volkswagen does it again.
Missile exercise, Atlantic Range.
1-0-0-25-9.
The Navy. Over 75% of our jobs give you technical training. Get one.
Target's turning starboard outbound.
Fire. Birds away.
Navy. It's not just a job. It's an adventure.
For the Houston Cougars, following the timeout, it is first down. Brent Chin is directing the attack. And for the Cougars, Alan Polk, junior tailback. Out over the 30 to about the 31-yard line. Darrell Clark, the tailback and the star of the game for the Houston Cougars. 151 yards, three touchdowns. And so he has gone to 1,000 yards.
Actually, and obviously, Navy should be playing run, and they are, but they're very vulnerable to the pass right now.
Polk and Newhouse are the running backs. This is Alan Polk, number 32. Not a first down. It'll be third down and short yardage. Again, linebacker Mike Kronzer of Navy is there along with Mike Rouser, the defensive right end, number 84.
Here's where the quickness of Brent Chin can be very, very helpful. takes that football out, gets the end caught in an option situation, and keeps the ball himself. Let's watch for number 8.
Second and 5 for the Cougars. This time it is Newhouse, number 28. Oh, beautiful tackle in the open field for Navy by John Ross, number 31, defensive halfback from Phoenix, Arizona. But he does get a first and 10. Another first down for Houston. Number 58 is Mickey Thompson, who handles the long snaps for the Houston Cougars.
Actually, Bob, on that last option, Mike Rouser played it very well. He forced the quarterback to pitch quickly, and he did, and did it well.
And they keep it on the ground. Alan Polk, the tailback, tugged down, and again, it is Mike Krunzer, number 63 for Navy. What a sure-handed tackler.
And again, they're going right after the quarterback. They're trying to take away that option, and in so doing, concentrating on the quarterback, they're opening up that middle.
And time has expired at the third quarter here at the Garden State Bowl. At the end of the third quarter, Houston 35 and Navy nothing. We'll come back for the fourth quarter in just a moment.
What a night. Blizzards in Alaska, typhoons in Tahiti, this close to a 747. And those snacks the kiddies leave, peanut butter in Poughkeepsie, bloodwurst in Bavaria. Oh, it's good to be home.
For headache and upset stomach, nothing works better, nothing is more soothing than Alka-Seltzer. No wonder it's America's home remedy.
Eggnog in Amsterdam, plum pudding.
We go to the fourth and final quarter in the third annual Garden State Bowl game. It has been quite a showing by Bill Yeoman's Houston Cougars. They finished at a tie for second of the Southwest Conference after last year sharing the title, going on to beat Nebraska in a thrilling game in the Cotton Bowl. In 5 years, they've either won or shared the conference crown 3 of the 5 since coming into the Southwest Conference.
You know, it's funny, not that it's funny, Bob, but this kind of reminds me of a game I played in so long ago with a great Don Faroe Missouri team when we were at Duke. It was the first time I'd ever seen the split tee. And frankly, after I saw it for the first time, I had hoped I'd never see it again. And this veer is working pretty much the way that split tee did then.
Bill Yeoman, since inventing the veer, so to speak, has had his team up among the nation's tops in total offense almost every year. Fourth quarter. Brent Chin is the sophomore quarterback. Here comes Brent Chin. Running all the way and taken down at the 46-yard line. Taken down at the 46 by Andy Ponciego, number 65, a freshman now getting some game time action. And another Houston first down. In passing here this afternoon, and it has been primarily a running ball game as we thought it would be. Houston has hit 3 out of 7 for 43 yards. Navy 5 out of 16 for 50 yards. This is first and 10 for the Cougars, and it is Alan Polk, the junior tailback, who took over at tailback after the Cougars moved to a big lead and after a very big day by the senior Terrell Clark. Travis Wallington of Navy made the tackle. Gain of 2, second down and 8. Houston will remain overnight in New Jersey. Have a visit into New York City, a beautiful time of the year to come and visit New Jersey and New York. The city is all dressed up with a big, beautiful Christmas tree. Brent Chin, oh, good hard hit. Right at the line of scrimmage for Navy, Ted Doombald made the stop, and it was a good one. He was helped out by Travis Wallington.
As I look at this veer formation, the thing that seems to work is obviously very disciplined football. You cannot go with the flow of that action. If you take any of those fakes, they're going to beat you.
If the Cougars come up with another first down, it will be their 24th of the afternoon. Brent Chin spinning and handing to Alan Polk, number 32. He's downed on the 40-yard line. Andy Ponciego was there to make the tackle, and that is not enough for a first and 10. It'll be fourth down, and I believe that if the Cougars punt, it'll be the first time all afternoon they've punted the football.
That's it.
It will be the very first time that Mark Ford, number 91, and that is John Ross, number 31 of Navy, dropping back. And here is the kick by Mark Ford, number 91. Oh, it just got into the end zone. It just goes into the end zone. Good try by Houston trying to prevent it from going in. And now it's Navy, first down on their own 20-yard line. Greg Harmon was going downfield trying to stop it. 12:55 left to play in the Garden State football game, and Houston out in front 35-0. And we'll be coming back for more of the action in just a moment.
Patrol 6 to base, Patrol 6 to base.
Roger, Patrol 6, reach out loud and clear. Go ahead.
Well, it looks like this big old hole in the ground is going to be safe for another night. We'll just finish this run, and we'll be back in about...
It's time to relax. One beer stands clear. You got the time.
We got the beer.
Come build the time.
Just
we got the beer.
Navy first and 10, their own 20. Fred Reitzel quarterbacking the midshipmen. Sherlock, the tailback, number 23. Running for five, being hit down by Lawrence Woods, a junior strong safety from Corrigan.
It hasn't been often, really, Bob, that the Navy team has had that situation where they made a significant gain on first down that gives them now the option of what to do, pass or run.
Second down and four, Fred Reitzel trying to hook up. And the pass wobbly and incomplete. Mike Sherlock, the tailback, coming out of the backfield, well covered by Joe Keyes, a senior linebacker, and Weedy Harris.
Now you might keep your eye on number 51 again, because now you've got them in the third down situation, and here's where that blitz kind of takes off. I don't know if Navy has the screen. I'm sure they do. We haven't seen it as yet.
This is third and four for the Naval Academy. From their own 25-yard line. The pitch is to Sherlock, the tailback. Good run across the 30, first down, out to about the 31-yard line. Being taken by Joe Keyes, the right linebacker.
You know, when you have the kind of speed that Weedy Harris does, there is a tendency to overrun the play. Let's watch him. He goes beyond it. He really took his eye off that runner, over-pursued, and they hit. Good block on him, but they hit behind him.
Steve Callahan is in as a wide receiver for Navy now, replacing Dave Dent. Fred Reitzel has to unload it to Kevin Talbert, and what a hit at the 20, at the 30-yard line. So Kevin Talbert hit down right at the 30-yard line. What a hit by Hosea Taylor and Leo Truss as they come back. So it's second down and about 10 and a half for Navy. They lost a half yard on the play.
And now the percentages on interception go way up because there's going to be a big rush, and that gives that secondary the chance to move to the ball.
Good Reitzel in one of those situations where you almost have to put it up every down. This time calls a running play to his tailback, Sherlock, and that Houston defense, well, it has been just about as effective all day long as the offense has been. Terry Monroe, number 99, leading the play defensively for Houston. Both teams have been very happy with the reception they've received at the Garden State Bowl. They were taken on a tour of New York City. Particularly for the Texas football team, many of the Houston Cougars had never been to the New Jersey, New York City area before. Third and 11. Fred Reitzel. For the near sideline, incomplete, intended for Papa John, the wide receiver. And that again was well covered. James Durham, a sophomore, number three out of Lufkin, Texas, being used now by Bill Yeoman. He has a chance to give his younger players some very valuable game experience with Houston so far out in front. They lead 35-0. There's a gorilla on the far side of the field, rooting for the Navy. Lex Lauletta will punt for Navy. Back to receive for Houston is Eric Herring. And he calls for the fair catch at his own 40-yard line. Eric Herring made the fair catch at the Houston 40. It'll be first and 10 for Houston on their own 40. And Allen doing a little fast work with the pencil here. The Cougars have 368 yards in total offense. We have a timeout on the field. It's 35-0. Houston has the lead. We'll be coming right back after these messages from your local station. Houston first down on their own 40. They lead 35-0, fourth and final quarter. Brent Chin quarterbacking and handing off to Ernie Wesley, who has just come in the game. Allen Polk, beg your pardon, number 32.
Allen just got that ball back. He did fumble.
Then they actually gain a yard to make it second down and 9 yards to go. In the backfield, running wise for the Cougars now, Allen Polk, number 32, and Ernie Wesley, number 36. Ernie Wesley is a junior for Marshall, Texas. And this is Brent Chin, now on the option, pitching back, fumble, loose ball, and diving for it, Brent Chin, the quarterback, and Chin does cover it for the Houston Cougars back at about the line of scrimmage. Boy, that was a quick scramble on the part of Brent Chin.
He is awfully quick. Bob, there really isn't much you can say when a ball game turns out like this. I guess the second series that Navy had the football and the loss of a great runner in Eddie Myers, a fumble that gave Houston a chance to score very early, was really all they needed. It was kind of the catalyst of the day.
Eddie Myers went out with a rib injury the second time he handled the ball. This is third down and 8. Allen Polk, number 32, over the 45 to the 46. Paul Soares of Navy, number 67, helped by Mike Kranzer, the linebacker, number 63. So fourth down, and for the second time today, Mark Ford, number 91, a junior from Mena, Arkansas, is the punter, dropping back John Ross, number 31, for the midshipman. Skies are overcast, temperature about 33 in New Jersey today. Good long snap. They had the rush on trying to get it. And it will be well covered by the Cougars. And Navy will have it on about their own 23-yard line. First down and 10 yards to go with 8:34 left in the game. It was 28-0 Houston at the half. Terrell Clark has scored 3 times, has rushed for 151 yards. Fullback David Barrett scored a touchdown, and the quarterback Terry Elston scored a touchdown.
Well, looking at the way in the offense that Houston is now using, Bill Yeoman is obviously trying to keep the score down. 35 is bad enough.
Navy first down on their own at 23-yard line. Sherlock is the tailback, number 23. He got outside all right and across the 25 to about the 27-yard line. Tom Tarquinio has come back in as the quarterback for the midshipman.
I guess the thing, Bob, that we talked about last evening at dinner really happened here today. Not only turnovers, but physically. You know, this Navy is a good football team. There's no doubt about it. But when they play a team that is enormous, and that is what you have to say about that Houston 3, just the physical difference is really where it was at today.
Second down, 5, Navy. Tarquinio. And the pitch is to Dwayne Flowers, number 25, who comes in as the tailback. And Leonard Mitchell, 6'7", 280-pound defensive tackle All-American. Enough for a first down for the midshipman. In the backfield now, the fullback in the eye is Kevin Talbert. He has played almost the entire game. And Dwayne Flowers, a junior, is now the tailback. Tom Tarquinio, a sophomore, and he's a good passer. 21 for 31 coming into the game today, is now directing the attack. First down play, Talbert, the fullback, hitting quickly. That's that quick hitter that's worked a little bit for them here today, and he goes out to the 41.
Of the 60,000 seats that were sold here, there was probably, upwards of 50, I'm just taking a guess, but remaining now, probably the middies are the most loyal, and they're sitting on the far side of the field. Meadowlands Stadium, Giants Stadium, is just about emptied out.
We're about to have a storm as we come toward the end of the game here. Al DeRogatis, big black cloud over there. I don't know whether it would be rain or snow. Might be snow. Sherlock, the tailback, throwing the pass. That is incomplete, intended for Papa John, the wingback, who is looking for an interference call.
He and Myers have thrown three passes this year, and that was the first one that was incomplete. That's the kind of day it's been.
Third and long for the midshipmen, the ball on their own 41-yard line. Temperature was about 33 at game time. I don't know really whether it's dropped or not. If it has, it won't be rain, it will be snow if we get it. And it is beginning to look a little bit stormy here in New Jersey. As we watch Tom Tarquinio throwing, and it is incomplete, intended for Greg Papajohn, the wingback, well covered by Butch LaCroix, a sophomore out of Tyler, Texas, and his fourth down, and I believe Navy will turn it over. Lex Lauletta, the Navy punter, is coming on the field. Number 21 is Eric Herring. He will take the deep drop on the punt. Herring, a wide receiver, serving as a punt return man along with Lonel Fee, and they're both outstanding. So now we'll watch Lex Lauletta. He'll hit it from about his own 30-yard line. Fair catch. Eric Herring grabs it at his own 28-yard line. So with 7:05 left to play in the football game, Houston riding a 35-0 lead, and we'll be coming right back.
Stepping out, eh?
Just a black tie dinner.
You sure do live well. Love to see what you drive.
Well, it is extraordinary. It has more luxury, more power, and yet more economy than you can imagine.
And it carries everything.
Impressive, isn't it?
You're going to a formal dinner in a Volkswagen pickup truck? Why?
Why? Why not?
Volkswagen does it again!
Flight operations, Hawaiian Islands.
155 is a go bird.
And the green stripe rudder.
Bring up 155 on number 2 elevator.
Cloud top to 28,000 feet.
Alpha Hotel, your wind is down the deck at 28.9.
The Navy. Over 75% of our jobs give you technical training. Get one.
Launch aircraft.
Engines and clear.
Speak to your local recruiter or call this toll-free number. Navy. It's not just a job. It's an adventure.
Well, the Houston cheerleaders have put their jackets on. The temperature has been dropping. Lionel Wilson is in as the quarterback. He is a freshman. And Alan Polk is the ball carrier. Polk, by the way, getting up close to 50 yards. He's played in the second half of the ballgame. Mike Rouser and John Ross of Navy made the tackle. Well, here's a freshman quarterback, Al DeRogatis, that Bill Yeomans is really high on. He's a six-footer, 201 pounds.
Well, Bill Yeomans told us also that next year he thinks his Houston team is really going to be competitive. Well, if it's next year, they're pretty good today.
The wide receivers lining up. Jimmy Wright is in as the wide receiver now. And this time, Lionel Wilson.
That had to be a broken play because it was a most unusual kind of a spin. I'm not sure if he ever got control of the ball. It looked like he was going to be handing off to his fullback. He was kind of searching for it. It looked like he didn't get control. Kind of a slow little turn.
Lionel Wilson, a freshman from Houston, Texas, is the quarterback for the Cougars now. They have the game under control. They lead 35-0. We're in the final quarter. Wilson faking to Alan Polk. Wilson still has it, running it very well. He'll be tugged down across the way at the 45-yard line by tailback, by the safety, Jeff Shoemake, number 14.
One thing the college quarterbacks have over the pro quarterbacks is that they forget the only time the pros run as old Dutch Van Brocklin used to say, is out of sheer fear. But these boys just like to run.
Bill Yeoman has Jimmy Wright in as a wide receiver along with Milton Watson now. He has the game under control. This is Jimmy Wright, number 86. That gives you an idea of the happiness and the chill. And now Lionel Wilson to Ernie Wesley. No, rather Alan Polk. Fumble, I believe, Navy. No, still loose. And finally claimed by the midshipman on their own 47-yard line. Unless there's a Cougar under there. It is Navy's football. Number 84 is Mike Rouser. Mike Crum, number 90, also a key figure in the play.
There were about eight fumbles earlier on in the football game. And here's another one. You go after it, bounces away, but here comes the Navy man from the right for the recovery.
First down, Navy on their own 46-yard line. 5:14 remaining of the third annual Garden State Bowl, a game that has been dominated by Bill Yeoman's Houston Cougars. And it has been surprising in the score in that George Welsh's midshipman of Navy won 8 out of 11 this year and posted one of the finest defensive records in college football. But today, Houston has put it all together. Tom Tarquinio of Navy is the quarterback, running after the roll over midfield into Houston territory to the 46-yard line. Weedy Harris, the sophomore linebacker, does the work on defense. Gain of almost 10. He picked up 9. It'll be second down and a yard to go now for the midshipman. Papajohn and Callahan, the wide receivers for the middies. Tom Tarquinio would love to get the midshipman on the board. Tarquinio for Callahan, number 22. It is incomplete. So it's third and one now for Navy. 4:37 left to play in the game. It was 28-0 at the half. Houston scored twice in the first quarter. Those are the hand warmers, and they've come in handy today. Happy Houston football team right now.
They sure are. Every one of them's on their feet.
Third and one. Sherlock for the first down. The tailback, Mike Sherlock, does get a first down. Navy keeps possession.
And the Navy team keeps trying. You know, you have to admire a team that is down 35-0 and still making that kind of a drive. I just think it's sort of symbolic of this Navy team. They're a classy bunch.
The last 3 years, Navy has been 9-3, 7-4, and 8-3. Tarquinio wants to throw fairly deep, and he hooks up at the 27-yard line. It is complete. The wide receiver, Dave Dent, number 86, was hit immediately by Calvin Eason. He took a hard hit. Another first down for the midshipmen. They started on their own 46-yard line. Tarquinio to Sherlock. Oh, Sherlock taken behind the line by Greg Harmon, number 44, only a sophomore from El Campo, Texas. And right now, Bill Yeomans is sending Leonard Mitchell and Hosea Taylor back on the field.
That's interesting. You know, he's left one of his big men in there. This is the first time, really, he's rested that defensive line. I guess he doesn't want to score.
He's trying to protect the shutout. It's second down and 14. Tarquinio is throwing for Kurt Gaynor, the tight end, number 87. And that is incomplete. Butch LaCroix covering for Houston. It'll be third and 14.
You see that the prevent defense. Now that prevent defense is going to prevent the deep pass. If the quarterback had the poise, and I'm not suggesting he doesn't, but he could have dropped one underneath it because he did have two people clear.
Butch LaCroix was doing the covering, a sophomore from Tyler. Wind is really picking up now here in the closing minutes of the game. And this is third and 13 for the midshipman. Tarquinio. Rolling. He's trying to run for the first down. He had much too far to go, and he's chased out of bounds by Joe Keyes, a senior linebacker. It'll be fourth and long now for the midshipman.
Well,
3:16 remaining in the Garden State Bowl game. Houston capitalized on turnovers and a long drive, and they scored twice in the first quarter, twice in the second, and they've scored once in the second half for a 35-0 lead. On a fourth down play, Tarquinio comes this way. Now he throws. It is broken up and incomplete. Batting it away was James Durham, a sophomore out of Lufkin, Texas, and the ball goes over to the Cougars. First and 10, Houston at their own 25-yard line with 3:10 left in the football game. Tremendous game played today by the Cougars of the University of Houston. Lionel Wilson, a freshman, is the quarterback. Here comes Lionel. Faking and running. And being hit down at the 30-yard line by Ken Fancher, a sophomore defensive end out of Altus, Oklahoma. So Bill Yeoman giving a lot of people a chance to play. Right now, let's switch to Howard Damon.
Okay, Bob, standing with me is Bob Beck, the chairman and chief executive officer of the Prudential Insurance Company, to present the Most Valuable Player Award. Not a big shock.
Not a big shock at all. But really a beautiful performance. You know, the halfback of the Houston team running for 163 yards, a new Garden State Bowl record, 3 touchdowns. A really super performance.
You're talking, of course, of number 26, Terrell Clark.
Terrell Clark is the man. He was the unanimous choice for the Most Valuable Player Award.
Thank you, Bob Beck.
And our congratulations to Terrell Clark, the Most Valuable Player of the third annual Garden State Bowl game. It's 3rd and 2 for Houston. Alan Polk and Ernie Wesley are the running backs, and the freshman Lionel Wilson is directing the attack as they run into the line in the hands of Ernie Wesley. And we'll see if that's going to be a first down. If it is, Houston will have 25 first downs in the football game. 25 Houston first downs, 11 for Navy. Time left in the Garden State Bowl game. 1:45, 35-0. Houston fumble, loose ball, and recovered by the Cougars at the 37-yard line. Alan Polk made the dive and covered the fumble to keep the ball in Houston possession.
Sure is interesting, Bob, the turnaround when you think Navy looks so great against the Army team. Not that Army is near Houston in talent, and Houston looked so terrible, as Bill said, it was a vacation for his team against Rice. To have this kind of a turnaround is just tells you the kind of talent we're looking at.
Shows you the emotion and intensity in college football. Yep. I never saw a better performance than Navy put together when they beat Washington, the team going to the Rose Bowl for the Pac-10. That was Ernie Wesley for the Houston Cougars. So Houston is going to finish the year with a record of 7-5, and they're quite a bowl team. Their bowl record will go to 7 wins, 2 losses, and 1 tie, and look at the Cougars. You think they're not a happy crowd? They have every right to be happy and also to be very proud of the way they have played here this afternoon. We're in the final minute of the football game. Lionel Wilson, the quarterback, pitching it back now to Alan Polk, number 32. Polk brings it up to midfield. And 31 seconds showing on the clock. Navy will call time to stop the clock as the tackle was made by John Foley.
Now, I think that's rather courageous of Navy, but guess what, Bob? I wouldn't have called timeout.
This is it.
Yeah, and it's kind of cold and blustery down on that field. It was 33 at game time. Next Friday night, Mizlou Television Network will be covering the Holiday Bowl from San Diego, California. You'll want to see it. Ernie Wesley is number 36 for Houston. Great day offensively and defensively for Houston. The defense was just intimidating. 5 seconds. The game is just about history. They're counting it down. That was the first play. Talk about a gun going off to end a football game. That was a cannon.
That was a cannon.
The cannon brings it to an end. The final score of the third annual Garden State football game, Houston 35 and Navy nothing. More when we come back in just a moment.
42.
Foul! What a call! What a heartburn. How do you spell relief? Check the board, coach.
R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Rolaid spells relief. Unbeatable relief. Relief Tums can't beat. Relief no other leading antacid can beat.
For comic relief, I put on a frown. But for acid indigestion, I spell relief. R-O-L-A-I-D-S. Unbeatable.
Rolaid spells relief. Unbeatable relief.
So the final score in the Garden State ball game, Houston defeating Navy by a score of 35 to nothing. Al DeRogatis and Howard David, pleasure being with you. It looks to me, gentlemen, like this football game wound up weather-wise at exactly the right moment.
Sure did. It was a pleasant day for everyone but the Navy team. I thought the halftime festivities were just outstanding. A beautiful day for the Garden State Bowl, and you're right, it's going to do something about now.
Look at head coach Bill Yeoman. He's pulled that stocking cap down over his ears. The wind has really picked up. I'd say it's about 35 miles, maybe 40 miles an hour right now.
And snowing.
And snowing, you're right. And a very happy Houston football team. They'll remain overnight, enjoy the sights of the big city, and then be returning to Houston, where Bill Yeoman will begin to think about his 20th football season. And we're about to have the presentation of the Garden State Bowl trophy.
It's Bill Hyland who has the trophy in his hand. Bill, very instrumental in the Garden State Bowl and its inception. As a matter of fact, Al, if I'm not mistaken, they have named, they will name one of the complexes, part of the complex here, in honor of Bill Hyland. I'm not sure if it's the racetrack or the stadium. No, it can't be the stadium. It must be the racetrack, because I think they're going to name the new arena in honor of the current governor of the state of New Jersey, Brendan Byrne.
I heard two of them. That was one that I heard. The other one I heard was that they were going to name one after Governor Bill Cahill also.
Talent, get ready to go on camera.
Nothing, the final score. The Houston Cougars will be going back home to Texas, a very happy football team. And I must say, we expected a very close football game here today. It was Navy, a team that had not turned the ball over at all. They did turn it over here today, and Houston, well, they were ready to play.
The football game was really over kind of early. I guess in this kind of a game, and I've been on both sides of this sort of thing, Howard, I can remember one great game we played. The final score was the New York Giants 7, and I think it was the Pittsburgh Steelers 63. So that's not a very pleasant day, but you kind of saw it coming. Houston had incredible intensity. The defensive three really intimidated, and that's where the football game went. And once you lose, now you're captain in McAllister because of the ruling, and also Eddie Myers, your top runner. That's the sort of thing that breaks the football team up. George Wells did such a great job all year, and I'm sure Howard, he's a little embarrassed by this today.
Well, he probably is. I was down in the Southwest yesterday, and the consensus of opinion as to how Houston would do today ranged anywhere from they would blow Navy out, as they did obviously, to they would come in with a rather lethargic attitude towards the football game. They came off a devastating loss to Rice in their last regularly seasoned scheduled football game, and how they would react into a bowl thing was something that was very much question mark in the southwestern part of the United States.
Well, you know, when you look at a team that really the last 3 out of 4 years, Bob, represented the Southwest in the Cotton Bowl, and many of the players are back from that great win over an awfully good Nebraska team of last year, you knew you had a football team here. And when you listen to Bill Yeoman, Bill is talking about next year being even better. So he just might be back in the Cotton Bowl. As you know, the winner of that conference must go to the Cotton Bowl.
The weather we have right now, as we see the snow flying around, must remind the Houston Cougars of the kind of day they had 2 years ago in the Cotton Bowl where they played Notre Dame. It was an unbelievably cold, windy day.
An old friend of yours, Lindsey Nelson, was down there.
Yeah, he sure was, and that was a game. I saw Houston get out in front 34-12. Notre Dame rallied, finally won at 35-34.
I tell you what, I'm just checking to see my back, and there's a hole in my back because that cannon just went off again, and it gets you a little shaky.
That cannon can really get your attention in a hurry. And it's filling the sky along with the snowflakes that are flying around.
And we'll be back with a final word from the Garden State Bowl, 1980, right after we pause for this message.
Take it easy.
You know, I was known for working long and hard during training camp. Why, even after my teammates were asleep, I'd still be out practicing my moves, and that's still important. So I drink light beer from Miller. Light tastes great. It's got a third less calories than a regular beer, and the best thing is it's less filling. Because, listen, I still train the same way as the old days. Practice, practice, practice.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
Promotional consideration furnished by Champion Products, makers of fine athletic uniforms, exciting campus sportswear, and imprinted leisure wear. Across America and around the world, it takes a little more to make a champion.
Couple of diehards still hanging out here at Giant Stadium. You can see the snow. It's ironic that as soon as the final cannon went off, the snow started coming, and I was wondering where they had the cannon pointed.
I think it's marvelous that this weather waited until just at the end of the game to join us. They had been forecasting the possibility of some snow in the New York area earlier in the weekend. That didn't develop, and it held off till the game was over.
I can promise you one thing. The next Mizlou Television Network telecast won't have snow. We'll be in San Diego, California on Friday night, the 19th of December. Ray Scott will be out there along with Grady Alderman, and Dwayne Dowd will bring you that telecast. And then Saturday, the 20th, from the Tangerine Bowl in Orlando, Florida. I don't believe we'll have snow there either. We don't have to worry about that. Now, Birmingham on the 27th, that could be a problem.
This has been an interesting little day.
That's Jimmy Miller, who's our handheld cameraman, and does such a marvelous job, and probably as difficult job as there is in a telecast.
He sure does. You know, and again today, they picked up that football so beautifully, particularly that one play where the punt hits the Houston Houston player, and the ball then was recovered by Navy. Another great day by them. We kind of compliment them. I just don't want them to get a big head, but they were pretty terrific.
And he must be delighted that the weather held off until the end as we take a look at the credits for the people who do so very much and do so very well for the Mizlou TV network.
And there are many. Many, many people that go behind the scenes to bring you the pictures that you see in front of the camera. Next weekend, Friday night, the Holiday Bowl in San Diego, 9 o'clock Eastern time, over most of these Mizlou Television Network stations. Until that time, for Bob Murphy and Al DeRogatis, final score 35-0 Houston. This is Howard David saying so long.
Promotional consideration paid for and provided by Ricoh's unbeatable combination of quality and cost performance. The easy-to-use Ricoh KR10 automatic and manual SLR camera. Ricoh KR10 system, when you aim to be the best.